People want you to vlog food. You have sunstroke.
Okay. No, no. Sagan is totally about ready to like eat the cables.
Firewire table.
Alright, good. Alright, I will vlog before we continue. Alright. What time is it? 8:30. Well, it's 8:30. We just got into the monkey caves. Monkey caves! We also got some food. My parents were very wonderful people and brought us a ton of chicken from Zaxby's. Even though we made chili. And the cat is chasing its own tail in my seat, which is fantastic. You guys will be able to see this in a bit. Well, in a few days as soon as I get all this done. We've currently raised near's a hair, $1,100, I think. It was like 1062 or 1069 or something. There's still 3.5 hours left, but we may be going into overtime because I don't think we're going to have the game finished by then. I've beaten the game super fast before. It's not happening. It's not happening. We've run into so many problems. I'm worried. Anyway, food's good. I'm going to keep eating and playing, and hopefully we will get through this before midnight. Maybe. Alright. I was all like, yeah,
people say it's desynced.
Huh?
People are saying it's desynced.
It's desynced? Desynced.
You should close that box.
We'll be alright. That might fix it. You have to let me know, but I have a feeling that that's probably a quick fix that might be that might make that work. All right. Can you give me a skip sandwich? I can.
Jeff has it.
No. Like, no, maybe I can.
You stop that kitten.
Give me lunch.
No.
No. Oh, Lord, you're heavy. There you go. Okay. Let's see if I can get through these stupid monkey games. Doing well, though. Okay.
Now it's worse.
It's gonna start getting a lot worse. We're just basically my. No.
It's not fixed apparently.
Huh?
It's not fixed apparently.
What's broken exactly?
It's about a half second delay. Now it's fine. Yeah, it's good. No, it's not. Yes, it is.
Okay. We're gonna leave it alone. Because I need to.
It's fine for me.
I'm trying to keep shaking off my food while I play and eat at the same time. There's too much to do. We got 3.5 hours. We're not going to be there for 3.5 hours. I don't know. I'm getting really worried. We'll see what happens, but we've been moving way too slow for this. Anyway, let's talk to this guy. I actually used to have a protein drink, but I sold it. Oh my god, I have a pizza. And you can have it, because I don't need it. Pizza time. That's what Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles say in Turtles in Time. When you touch the little thing that makes you spin around.
Pizza time.
Alright. You want the King Banana?
Oops.
No. And you are... You want a hamburger. I don't think I have a hamburger, do I? No. Dang it. Alright. By far the most confusing part of Earthbound. Confusing as to why it exists, mostly. Okay. Still have not had any stupid chicken. I've eaten only french fries.
Chicken's good.
I believe you. I really wish I could eat some. Maybe you should do half of the monkey cave. I don't have a fresh egg, dang it. Okay, what do you got? I don't have no freaking ruler. Okay. Gotta go back. Gotta go back. And... Can we go this way now? No, we were already that way. Or did we get what we needed to... Mario, you're getting confused. Ah, oh, piss. No, not you. Which one did this one want? Yeah, I need one of them. We got one of them. Get out of the way, monkey. Monkey. Good monkey. Bag no. of Dragonite. Unfortunately, that's not one of the items we need to give to people. It's just a free item. Nah. You gotta go all the way back up to the very front room, and then go in. It's a process. I am chilling on the prize. Stay good. Whoa. You want me to the front? Was that the front? Oh, that was the front. Piss. Dang it. Let me see what these guys say so I remember. Lucky. Okay. So we came from the right, we're going to the left now. Got the pizza. Yay. Placing my pizza. I will give you a wet towel. And you want a pizza. I have another pizza, actually. You are in frickin' luck. Okay, let's go in here. Excuse me. Hamburger. Like I needed that. A ruler. There's so much backtracking in this thing. I love hamburgers. The monkey next to me also loves hamburgers. We are friggin' confusing. Hamburger. A flame pendant. Also something we won't trade. I don't think we have any other extra hamburgers, do we? Why can't you take a double burger? It's like twice as nice. Darn it. Alright. Back we go. I'm eating a lot of fries right now. Now we go in here. What do we got? A pizza, again. Okay. That would be the pizza to keep. Okay. I'll give you a fresh egg. Okay, dang it. Here we go. This is gonna be hard. We've got to backtrack all the way back. And make sure we go in the right place, because if we take too long, it'll turn into a chick. So we have to hurry.
You know where to go?
Not really. It's in here. I figure I have about as good a chance as anyone else. I'm gonna take a chance and go to the right. Because I really do not remember. I was right! Hot dang. Jeff has it. Get the crap out of my way, monkey. I'll whip your little monkey butt. Move! Stupid monkey! We gotta be about there. A neutralizer, yay! Not what I cared about at all. What did this person want? A ruler. Got one. Please move. Thank you. Alright. One of my friends can use the teleport. What? You've never heard of it? Then I'll give you King Banana. That didn't make sense, did it? But anyway, I'm attractive, don't you think? Not really into that, but Jeff is. Just got King Banana. Now we have to go all the way back and figure out where that guy was that wanted King Banana. And hopefully Kepler won't eat the prize. I think it was in here, maybe? I ate an entire thing of fries. I have not had any freaking chicken yet. I need to eat the freaking chicken.
Kittens are getting the fries.
There are no fries, I ate them all.
Close it up though.
Okay. I've died to go to monkey heaven. Well then, die and get out of my way. What's next? We are like freaking there, aren't we? Hamburger! Yay. Picnic lunch. Finally. There's, if you go back, you can give the hamburger to someone else. I don't remember what happens, though. Let's go ahead and get rid of this thing. Is this in front of my face and I don't see it?
What is it for?
Oh, there it is. Awesome. Finally made it. Okay. This wasn't that bad. Let's, we don't need the Great Charm, do we? And we don't need, picnic lunch.
Not anymore.
We're gonna need, we need three spots, because we need this stuff.
Whoa!
And we also need to get the, yogurt dispenser. Right?
Yes.
So we need to get rid of something else. Let's get rid of the double burger. No, hamburger. Haha! Screw you, hamburger. Now we can talk to this guy. Truth of space and time moves through the universe like a wave. Truth speaks through space and matter and makes itself known to human beings. I was waiting for you when you came. This was destined to happen. In truth, all is predetermined. Ness, Paula, Jeff, and Pooh. When these four powers gather, twisted space will bring back peace to the world.
And Captain Planet will come back and save us all.
Do you understand? It doesn't matter. Proceed as you wish. Open the treasure box and take what is inside with you. Did you come in search of this? Someone left it behind in this hole. Yay! Ness got the yogurt dispenser. The adventure that lies ahead won't be easy. I'll give you a special skill to help you move through space as you wish. Learn the skill from the monkey over there. Would you like to learn the special power? Yes. That's wonderful. Speak to the monkey. Monkey. I'll teach you teleportation. Let's go outside and let's make you walk through everything again. Now we walk outside. No, cat. Cat is not that far away from Kep, which is what I should say practically all the time. I haven't fought any enemies, don't need that. Let's go outside. Oh my god, I'm almost done.
You could use the exit mouse.
You have one? No, you don't.
Someone suggested it.
Oh. They're one-time use. We used it. We grabbed one and used one in the earlier thing. Follow me, like this way. Hold on. I have to instantly kill this red-nosed fool. Got him. Ness and Jeff get a lost variance. Let's go down here. Okay, I'll do a teacher's demonstration. If you can learn this, you can go anywhere you've been previously except Happy Happy Village. If you can go there instantly, the skill can't be used in a room or underground, though.
Are we gonna find out now?
I know! I know 100% certain. If you wanna bet, let's bet right now, because I'm about to get whatever the deal is.
I just wanna be able to say I'm right.
You're wrong. I went to Foresight and returned. I showed you the basic straight course. You can also build up enough speed. Blah, 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 blah. You did it! Bye! That's basically what he says. Should I chase him down?
No.
Should I have a skip sandwich? I could chase him down?
No. I'm saying you should find anything good, happy, happy village. Okay, you're right.
I know. I know, I'm right. Now back to Foresight?
Yeah.
I mean, are you playing at this point?
Yeah, what's next? Monosoli?
Monosoli.
I'll do it. You can take this.
More importantly, can I eat?
Yeah, you can do that too.
Here. Oh! Here you go. You die, it's your fault, you were playing. Alright. Let's see here. I'm gonna check the donations and read the comments on them. I'll do it right now, folks. I am still impressed that we've managed to keep at least 500 people the entire time we've been streaming. That's bizarre. Especially as we enter into the late night. Haven't updated a while on the donations, so I'm going to look at them now. Let's do it now!
Dang
it. We'll do it live!
Another text.
Donations building! The power level is high. Power level stuck at 605. There it goes. $1,079! Almost to $1,100. Awesome. So incredible. latest donations. Let's see. I last read the one from Denmark, so we need to hit up. Lucian Corvo donated and said, I just saw that I would donate a little money. I have a YouTube called Psy, PSI Yoshi. Eli Don donated and says, hey, me and my boyfriend, Eli 301 Don, pronounced E. Oh, actually pronounced Ellie. Well, I guess I was right the first time. And LOL64 Men are huge fans. You guys are heroes. Alex R. also donated. And Jordan Mons, the Fife Nation, says, only can give $5 now. Really appreciate what you're doing, Stephen. All four of you folks. Four? There wasn't five, right? Four. Yeah, four. Thank you so much. Awesome. And like I said, we've hit 1079, which is pretty impressive. We still have a few hours. We'll see what happens. I think we'll hit, you know, at least $1,100. It's obviously slowed down a little bit, but still pretty awesome. I don't think we're going to hit, like, 1,500, but the goal was $500. I mean, did pretty good. So, all right. I'm going to start looking at the chat again, but I'm also going to eat, because I'm really hungry. Kepler, no. No. Go away. Go away, because you want food. You need to exit. Go over there. I'm gonna get this whole big thing of chicken. Try not to get it all over Mel's laptop. Somehow. Kepler is now up on the table, like, hey, I know you got food. I know you got food. Can you guys see him?
I don't think so.
No, I don't think so. Okay. How am I gonna...
I don't know.
What am I gonna do?
I don't know. I'm getting his face out of the ketchup.
Hey, no, no, get down. Get down. Get down. No, 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 get down. No, bad, no. No. God, he doesn't get it. Or if he does, he's just mean and terrible. No, Sagan is smart. Why are you?
Sagan was sitting up there too.
Yeah, but when you tell Sagan to move, he like cowers. He's like, oh gosh, they're gonna get me. And Kepler's like, what? I'm just gonna eat your food. What's the big deal? Kepler, no, no, get down. Any luck, I can consume dinner. That would be nice.
Ness, only you may go. Jeff must wait in the lobby.
But wait, what's the plan? Why do I got? Jeff, shut up. No one likes you. There's a lot of Jeff hate. Put this down here so I have a room. A table next to me of food. Alright, so now Mal is in the Montatoli building. She has to get to, Montatoli, and be all like, hey, bro, and then we get Paula back.
Sentry bots. What?
What? Did he kill Jeff?
Yeah, he did.
Well, that sucks. Could be in a lot. Huh. Why'd you let him die?
Good. Let no one come to your aid.
Chicken is delicious.
It is good.
Zaxby's.
I mean, it's Zaxby's. Flash beta. Jeff, do you have the yes?
Good luck. You lucky. Alright. Steven, everyone is saying it's laggy, please look. Who's saying it's laggy? Is it laggy? I can't see the thing, but it seems like it's okay. There's far more people saying no. More than likely, if you're saying yes, it might be your connection. Yeah, our FPS is higher than it was earlier. When the stream started, it was really low. From restarting the stream, it's actually really high again. Like, it's at 30, so... should be fine. Everything should be A-OK. I'm sorry if you're having problems. I got 99 problems, but lag ain't one. If you're having lag problems, I feel bad for you, son. I will never do that again. This is good, Jimmy.
Oh, thank God. Bottle rocket did not work. No! Kids playing the cord.
Someone sent me Nintendo fan art, I think. Also, I'm eating my bag. Oh, man! It's awesome! You see that? She's in the game. Mr. Toto, I hadn't seen it because I haven't been paying attention much to the stream. Mr. Toto has fan art, and it's everyone being killed by all the slimy little piles. Fantastic job, excellent, love it. That's hilarious. That's awesome. Thank you. Someone says the game sounds completely out of sync. Is it? But completely.
Oh, I gotta fight Clumsy Bot, don't I?
Easy.
Yeah, I know.
For the record, I spoke in the Nintendo voice earlier. I'm trying to use this with my thinking. I can speak in the Nintendo voice with them. But I'm gonna eat. And then we'll talk about dead.
Get him! Get him!
He's not doing anything. No. He's on the floor.
No, they keep missing.
Oh, the clumsy robot. That was fast. Normally he eats a lot of bologna sandwiches.
He only managed to eat one.
I don't know where that guy hides all his bologna sandwiches, honestly.
In his head. He's a robot.
Marriage. In a nutshell, marriage. Anyway, Nintendo voice before I go back to eating. Hello everybody, and thank you for continuing to tune in to the stream. It's very polite of you, and we really appreciate you continuing to donate monies to the children. Also, this chicken is very freaking good. And, bats. And that's it.
Where do I get the chocolate yogurt from? Oh, there she is.
Found her. This is good. I'm overeating.
Stop.
It's good.
Put it in the fridge.
It tastes so good. Hey, no. 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 Last thing we need is for Kepler to chew through the microphone cable. Oh, man. Cream Cakey, what did you say? Cream Cakey says, it's like he sees everyone's but mine. I'm looking at the chat. I'm watching for your voice now. Say what it was, because I can't scroll up because my hands are full. Paste your message back. Someone said, would you consider playing Minecraft as Nintendo? No, not today. Sometimes I will do things like that, but not. I can't do it today. Oh yeah, it's slow mode, so it will take a while. I forgot. My bad. Okay. Alright, hold on, it's a link. Clicked it. Okay, what is it? Oh, man. Oh, that's awesome also. And really, this is probably really accurate because the slimy little piles are so small. When you think about it, they're just vomiting onto, like, Ness's ankles. Everyone else is dead. Ness can't run away and he's sitting there. Kill me now. That was such a sad moment. We used like 30 to 45 minutes on that, just sitting there like, oh, I wonder if we can get through this. No, we can't. Awesome. Thank you. Thank you so much for the arts. That's just so good. Shade Black Roses also posted some slowly. Also very nice. Excellent. Your ghosts. See, you can actually see what I'm thinking about. Your slimy little piles remind me of the Pac-Man ghosts. I also really like your dead Paula and Jeff. They look so peaceful. They're so happy. They're so happy to be dead. Actually, they probably were. Ness was the one that was not having a good time. Ness is like, please, I just want to be dead. Oh, crap. I closed the stream. Dang it.
Man, shifty.
Your stupid computer took so long that I thought it didn't get my initial...
I know, right? Why do you think I'm happy to have your computer now?
That's ridiculous. Your computer's awful. Terrible thing. Should be shot. Sorry, guys. Reloading the chat.
Should be shot.
I'm going to shoot it. It's giving me time. Zach's sauce tastes like.
You should try it. What other options did they send?
There's Zach's sauce,
ranch.
Ranch and ketchup.
Oh.
Do you watch Dragon Ball Z Abridged? I've seen like one episode of it before or something. I mean, it's not something I regularly watch. I maybe have seen more than one. It's funny. That's good. Someone asked where we are now.
We're going to Summers. No.
We're going to Summers?
No, we're
going to Winners.
We're going to Winners, and then Summers.
Progress. The game will really fly by now. Because the game, in my opinion, the game lags on a lot for the first two cities. It gets better for three, Dusty Dunes Desert and Foreside. But once you get out of Foreside, and you start, because the cities after that aren't connected, it makes it feel like it goes way freaking faster.
Mm-hmm.
So she's going to go kill the fourth Sanctuary Guardian at Winters, then we'll be in Summers, we'll get Pooh, and Scaraba, whatever, and then we get the Hawkeye, we lose Pooh, which is stupid.
Brick Road. Deep Darkness.
The Tenda Village.
Lost Underworld.
Yeah, then we get,
Then Fire Sprite.
And then Saturn Valley, and we're done with the game.
Yeah.
Now, everything I listed, can that be done in 3 hours?
I don't know. I mean, we're gonna keep playing.
We're gonna finish the game.
And then we may stream something else just to.
Yeah, I kind of understand.
For fun.
Yeah, but I feel bad.
Yeah.
I was like, ah, dude, Earthbound? We know that game like crazy, yo. We done got married because of that. And then it turns out...
Your southern roots are showing.
Sorry, excuse me. And then it turns out that we could not finish by 8 or 9. I really did think that we were going to get finished by now. I really thought that we'd be on the final battle right now. Nope. Not at all. Someone asked, are you a greaser or a sock? Or maybe aggressor? I don't know what that means.
I don't know.
Someone asked if I'd like to hear a joke. You're probably best to just type a joke.
Where do I go?
Huh? Where do you go?
Yeah.
Are you kidding me? Are you serious right now? Are you being serious?
I'm in 3. married. Where do I go?
You really don't know?
I'm having a blank.
Where are you going next?
Winners.
How do you get to Winners?
Oh, yeah.
It's up there. Just need to tell. Also, fun fact, in case you don't know a lot about Earthbound, after you beat the zombies and you come into Threed, there are no enemies in Threed. It's the only city
that continually has no zombies. Or any enemies after?
The Lamb doesn't have any enemies.
Oh.
Is that it? I think that's it. That and the Lamb. The Lamb never has any enemies, but this is the only other city that doesn't have any enemies. Happy Village, after you beat that, doesn't have any enemies. I'm gonna try to buy this with the Zach sauce. It's good. It's not spicy.
You promise?
I promise.
Don't shove it in my face.
I'm sorry. Being helpful. You like it? It's a little different, but it's good. It's got good flavor. Thumbs up, bro. Alright, back to the comments. What would you do if you woke up in Ravenholm? Be scared, probably. Aristarchus 1, glad to talk to you as well. Have you seen any interesting Dreamcast games that list people sent you? Yeah, actually someone sent me a really, really, really detailed list of games. YouTube, like a YouTube message, and it was pretty cool. There's a lot of games that like I've been familiar with that I didn't realize was on Dreamcast first. Like, is it Arcadia, Skies of Arcadia, or Skies of Something, which is a really popular GameCube game that's worth a lot of money now, was apparently on Dreamcast first. There's a few other ones going to completely escape my mind right now. Wow. It's interesting. Also, Shenmue.
That's a game I want to play.
Yeah, I want to play I've never played Shenmue. And there's Shenmue 2 is on Xbox. Aren't they remaking Shenmue in HD, or they're going to?
Maybe.
Or they are, like, they already have or something? I don't know. I'd like to play that. You guys let me know, because I don't know. I have played Golden Sun. I bought it on release. It is a fantastic game. I haven't played any of the sequels, though. I am very, very familiar with Harvest Moon, yes.
Monkey!
Chibi Robo is the little robot that carries the plug above its head or something, right? I played like a demo or something of that in the store one time. It seemed interesting. We are going to return to Minecraft custom maps when Donkey Kong Country 2 ends. I do like Shawshank Redemption. It's the best movie. Oh my god, I need to drink something by the meeting. We actually have played Minecraft pretty recently. Someone said, "Why are you ashamed of Mystery Dick?" Oh my god. I'm not ashamed of Mystery Dick.
My favorite part is Dan.
I'm not ashamed of Mystery Dick. I'm not. I don't think it's the best thing we ever made by a long shot, but it's pretty funny. It's kind of inappropriate. The writing is pretty atrocious, but I didn't write it, so I feel okay. The editing is spot on, and that's what I did, so I feel fine about it. Probably not a movie to show your grandma, but okay. Now people are like, who's Mystery Dick? Okay.
Do I go in here?
No, Shroom is up there.
Oh, there.
Yes. Anyway. Go to Vimeo.com, type in Mystery Dick, and if it doesn't come up, type in like Mystery Dick, Steven George, Should probably show up. Student film I worked on with a bunch of other guys. I did the editing. I actually filmed most of it, too. I didn't film all of it, but I filmed most of it. I filmed parts that make sense. If there's any angles or something looking stupid, I didn't do that. But I did everything else. I didn't write it, so. The writing's a little weird. But it was a funny thing. Anyone who watches the vlog will get a real big kick out of it, because it features a lot of the people who were in the vlogs that were my roommates. So, let's enjoy it. Did we beat the game? Oh god, no. Yeah, someone said it was the blue crayon. Hey kids, wanna go smoke some ice cream? I think I did the voice for that. I must have, because...
You're poison.
Healing beta. Because I just did that voice and it sounded exactly like the video, so I must have done the voice. I don't remember, but I guess I did. Oh lord, is it awkward to vlog?
Oh, I did the wrong one.
My advice is not to do the wrong one. The score out of 10 will get the top 9,000 video. 10!
We forgot about magic hint. We gotta do magic hint.
We're moving along. I just want to throw this out and boost my ego right now. I got through the friggin' mole caves like you wouldn't friggin' believe. I was just boom, 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 boom. I took those things out, man. I was in there for like 25 minutes tops. And I was out. And I went through the monkey caves fast, too. Just say.
Yeah.
Done well. That's pretty good.
Oh, we got sleepy kitties. On the same chair, Sharon.
My name is Steven.
Oh, baby.
Not Sharon.
They're sharing the chair. Oh, baby.
Roger, Roger.
That rocks. Oh, baby. Oh, baby. Oh, baby, sweet.
I'm scrolling up.
For what?
Looking for a message.
That one? That one?
No.
That one?
No.
That one?
No.
That one?
Someone said that they said, Cy, I have to keep reposting so he'll see it. So I scrolled all the way up and it says, hey Steven, will you send jitters to my house because my mom has, because my do has fleas, my dog has fleas and my room is carpet and now my room. I scrolled all the way up for that. It doesn't make sense. I was like, I felt really bad because I read his comment and I was like, oh, I feel bad. So I went up and found it and it wasn't an actual question. And I was like, I'm gonna scroll back down. Locoon has a question about mail videos. Shoot, and I will do my best to make sure I'm looking at this when it's posted. We have it set up where we don't get swarmed. That's why it's on slow. But the fact of the matter is, there is a chance that I won't see your message. It's just the way it is. It's sad, but that's just kind of the way it is.
What else am I supposed to do?
Did you kill it?
Never mind. Yeah. I got it.
Steven, will you play the Gen 5 Pokemon games?
I got in there and started doing the Skyrunner music. I was like, doo doo doo, bring, bring.
Oh, I was wondering, I was like, he should have called an hour ago, but I realized I had to restart, remember? Because I ended in, yeah.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. 2 hours ago, we were in the desert, apparently. Will I do the Gen 5 Pokemon games now? As a general rule, all games are a possibility. I think if I do a future Pokemon game, I would do one I've never played before, like a Gen 5, and make it a blind OP, just because it would probably be a little more interesting. Maybe not more interesting, just like a different kind of interesting. You know, another kind of interesting. I'm getting really cool.
This is one of my favorite parts.
I the captain.
I love how it was fine before, and then it fixes it, and it comes here and doesn't do a thing.
If someone sends you a puzzle or challenge, will you complete it in the mail episode? It really depends, like, how easy it is, pretty much. Like, someone sent us a Mad Libs one time, and we did it because it was, you know, it didn't take very long to do, and it was fun. You just have to remember that we are making, like, 80 videos a month. A lot of time is used to make the videos, so we try to get through mail videos as quickly as we can. And even if it's edited down, I mean, even if we edit out all of the parts of us trying to think or figure out the puzzle, we still have to do that off camera, so just kind of remember that. If you're going to send something in that would require, you know, if it's a puzzle or something, just keep that in mind, that we have to actually do that, and we are already really, really super busy, so, you know, if it doesn't take super terribly long, then we might do it. But there's a chance that if I feel like it's going to take too long to do, I may just say, you know, we'll do this later, and then not worry about it, so. Oh, we're in Summers, by the way. What are you doing? You have to go get the number for the Stove Club.
Oh, yeah.
Head right.
We live in Summers. Pretty much.
Rock on. I'm full. Oh, my God.
Stop eating then.
It was good. It was very good. There's still a lot of chicken left. The boys are asleep. It's really nice. Alright, I'm putting this in the fridge because I'm going to explode.
Kitty cat! Kitty cat!
This works. I put this in the refrigerator. And also...
in my stuff?
Can you lift this up for a second?
Go ahead.
I'm gonna throw these away. We probably won't need them anyway. I'll put this in here. Only one of them's empty. This one's empty. Oh man, who are you gonna name the player? Extra Life?
That might work. What do you think?
Name it, all all the donators. I think that would be good. And you can do it lowercase or uppercase, whatever. That might be good. You can just type all the donators. Because it's all about the prayers, man. And that would be good.
And I will... I guess we don't need this ketchup anymore, right?
Space by going under R. Yeah.
And I'll get us some tea.
You want ice or not?
I'll have a little ice. Again later, doesn't he?
Well, he just confirms it. You don't have to re-enter it. He just asks it.
Okay, well, you may want to confirm that I spelt it wrong. Someone said I did. But it's hard for me to see right now.
Misspelled donators?
That's what they said. But didn't you see it when I put it on there?
No.
Okay, well, maybe you should have checked that.
Well, you had to erase everything anyway.
Well, I spelled it the same.
How do you spell donate?
Like, I put donate.
D-O-N-A-T-O-R-S.
I don't remember. You'll have to check it when it happens again.
Okay.
Did you get the Stoic Club number?
Yeah, that's okay. Where I'm going.
Ooh, that's good. Ooh, I haven't had sweet tea in a while.
I have some. Will you hand it to me? Ooh, that's expensive.
Don't buy anything here. You can buy everything. You can practically buy everything here in Scaraba, and it's cheaper. So.
Someone said I spelled it right. That's how I spelled it.
Yeah, that's how you spell donators. Oh, yeah, that's pretty good. Actually, it says pretty good.
You taking my laptop?
Yeah, sorry. Alrighty. Alright, folks. Apparently, we broke 1100. Freaking awesome. I'm gonna reload and take a look. Thanks for letting me know that, by the way. Like, thanks for saying that in chat so I can go and double check and stuff. And yeah, we are. 1104. Awesome. And I apologize, you know, if you post something in chat and I don't see it because there's a lot of people in there and I'm gonna miss stuff. I mean, we have it on slow so I can try and read it and I'm still gonna miss stuff and I apologize for that. We had another anonymous donation, and the comment simply says, awesome. So thank you, awesome anonymous. Back to the chat. Stephen Amell, how long is Earthbound? Well, at most it should have taken us like 8 hours. I mean, maybe 9, at most like 10. Now we've been playing as of right now for 9 hours, and It shouldn't have taken us this long, but we ran into some problems. What's happening now? Mal went to Winters, killed Shroom, got the 4 Sanctuary location. We need 8, so we have half of them. Once again, I know what you're thinking. You're like, oh god, that means we're only halfway done. Not exactly. We have some of the ones at the end start running together really quickly. So, she used the Skyrunner to get to Winter's, kill Shroom, get to 4 Sanctuary location, took the Skyrunner to Summers, because you can't get to Summers otherwise, you have to teleport from here on out, and got the number to the Stoic Club, where they have a rock on stage and drink water and talk about philosophical things, and she just talked to a woman who said that she made magical cake, which is more like LSD cake. We had a bite of this LSD cake, and now Ness is kind of went out, and he's having a dream. But the dream turns out to be real. And we're dreaming of a place called Dalam in the Far East, and we are now going to be controlling Pooh, who is the Crown Prince. And there he is, sitting on his little throne there. And now it's time to control Pooh. Prince Pooh, the time has now come for you to unshake your final trial. Go to the place of emptiness and endure this final test. I am praying for your success. All right.
Whoa. Whoa.
Acid trip.
Friend. Actually, this is friend. friend.
Someone says, do you think that one of the anonymous donors is Mr. Dyslexic Heart Bear? Yes. And I think. Can you guys end the stream by doing the Gangnam Style dance? By the time we go to end the stream, it'll be quiet hours here at the apartment. For the record, we live in an apartment that is that has a ton of old people. And you might think, oh, that's supposed to be awful and boring. No, that's awesome. No, you want a lot of old people because it keeps it quiet. We're probably the loudest people, and we do a pretty good
besides
job.
Besides the people above us?
Yes. They are not loud people. They just have really big dogs. Oh, God, the cats are cute. Very cute. Very freaking cute. Anyway, back in the chat. Someone wants to know who inspired me to start doing LPs. I've answered this question many times in many places in a different variety of ways, but the general answer has been I didn't really have inspiration to start doing Let's Plays.
I'm stealing from my subjects.
Terrible.
Whoa!
I learned what Let's Plays were because of Chugga Conroy. Me and Emil had been friends for a long, long time, and he started sending me these videos of him doing commentary over games, and he wanted me to critique them. He was like, you know, is the editing good? Is this good? Is that good? How does it look? I'd never seen these things before. I was like, I don't know what this is. But I, you know, he seemed to enjoy it, so I, you know, critiqued them and gave him advice for editing and things like that. And more or less, he would generally come to me at the start of every new series. He'd give me the pilot episode and ask me to check it out. And he still does that today, but he was doing that back when. So I would check it out, and I gave him advice and stuff. But that was how I first learned what Let's Plays were. And after I got more into YouTube doing Steven Vlog, I decided, since he was having so much success with it, I was like, you know, I think I could do this, and it seems fun. I think I'll give it a shot. So that's how I started doing Steven Plays. And that's how I got started. So it's I wouldn't call him an inspiration.
Whoa.
It's not that I watched Emil's stuff and was like, oh man, I really want to do this. Because it was more or less like he was like, hey, could you critique this? And I learned what Let's Plays were through his stuff. And even today, I don't really watch a whole lot of content on YouTube. I'm just really busy. I don't have a whole lot of time. So I don't know if that counts as inspiration. But that's my story. I hope that answers your question. What was your very first Super Nintendo game? Donkey Kong Country. When I got the Super Nintendo, it wasn't right when they first came out, it was later on, and there was a Donkey Kong Country bundle. It came with Donkey Kong Country and you know, I don't know. It might have come with Mario World, or it might have come with All-Stars, or maybe both. I don't know. It was a good bundle. But I would say, by far, the first game I ever played was Donkey Kong Country, because I remember the Christmas morning I opened that Super Nintendo, and I ripped open freaking Donkey Kong Country and put that cartridge in the slot. Oh my god. I remember it like it was yesterday. Good times. Good times. My life. I've had a good life because I've played Super Nintendo. I grew up in Super Nintendo era, and it was a good time. Let's see. We got the same bundle, I'm pretty sure we'll see Mario World. Yeah, that makes sense, because I can see my family purchasing Super Mario All-Stars, because me and my dad...
It's just a flesh wound.
It's just a flesh wound. I can see me and my dad playing the old Mario, because we had it for NES. So it seems more unlikely that we would have bought Mario World. I was most excited to play Donkey Kong Country. Anyway. This is a fantastic event. This just adds on to more of the greatness that is Earthbound. Earthbound has so many memorable parts in it.
And this part is dark.
There's a lot of dark parts. I mean, even earlier I was talking about how they were going to offer Paula as a human sacrifice and stuff. Like, it's pretty dark stuff, deep stuff. So. Oh man, this is funny. Someone asked, Steven, do you like Dark Cloud, or have you heard of it? Earlier in the day, like 2 o'clock or something, someone asked us the same question. They were like, do you like Dark Cloud? You played the first one.
Yeah.
And me and her both own the second one. And I've played a great deal of it, but I never beat it. But it was fun. There's just lot of grinding.
I've beaten the main story. There's secondary stuff that happens after. Which I got about halfway through, and I still have a save file.
I like the idea of leveling up your weapons, which isn't exclusive to Dark Cloud, but I just like the way they did that.
With the different spheres and different lines and
stuff. I did not like the fact that you had to run around town and take pictures of everything.
You don't have to do that, like, completely.
And I don't like... I mean, there was some stuff that was really cool, really involved, but it was almost too involved. Where you have to, like, plant cities or something.
You have to build cities and restore them so that in the future they exist.
And then you go into the future. Yeah, like, there's some... If you don't have a player's guide...
We have one. It's on the shelf.
Yeah, well, I did.
You didn't. I had it.
Stephen Mao, do you like Donkey Kong 64? Have you ever played that?
Uh-uh.
I 100%ed Donkey Kong 64. Bought it on launch. And 100%ed it, which is saying something, because that is a collectible nightmare. But looking back on it, I've played it since then. It's not that it's a bad game, it's just, it's Banjo-Kazooie. It's Banjo-Kazooie with Donkey Kong characters, and I prefer Banjo-Kazooie. If you gave me the option between Banjo-Kazooie and Donkey Kong 64, I would much rather play Banjo-Kazooie. It's a better game. And they're both made by Rare. They're both good, but try to play the answer.
We have all four now.
We got Boo, yeah. Awesome.
Whee.
Museum.
I know, but it's just so much fun to have all four and be like, look.
Okay. Your face cam looks a bit dark. I bet I can fix that. It is dark. I was saying that last night. Can you hold that?
Yeah.
Can you continue to play somehow?
You said it on the cord.
Sorry. I'm going to see if I can fix this real quick. Because I bet I could. It should just be a matter of... Oh, I can make it darker. Not what I want. Hold on. Let me do... Is that what I want? Yeah, that's not terrible. Okay, does that... You guys still see that?
Much better brightness. Better.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I should have done that a long time ago. The, what do you call that? I just needed to adjust the f-stop. And I should have done that a long time ago. But now you guys can actually see. It's probably a little yellow. Anyway. Can you make a day to show us how to make pizza? I probably have done that.
I have, actually.
It's not that I particularly remember that right this second, but I know I probably have made a few of those. Just go to Stephen Vlog in the search box. Type in how to pizza tutorial or something. I probably have done it. I know I've done it for Sam. Steven, I'm Ultimate Gaming Goddess. Hey man, how was PAX in your opinion? It was awesome. It was awesome enough to make us want to go to PAX East. If you guys didn't know, me and Mal have our PAX East tickets, and we are in the process of working on, you know, hotel and flight and everything, so we're good to go. Me and Mal will be at PAX East. Hope to see you there. It's in Boston, Massachusetts. If you don't know what it is or don't know about getting tickets, it's too late because the ticket sold out in a few hours. But we're going. Me and Mal are going. Dan and Taylor are going. Dan and Taylor are going to be there. Paul is going to be there. Alex might be there. He's not 100% sure. He did get a ticket, but he's not 100% sure if he can go yet. So lots of cool stuff coming up. Steven, will you ever do a long LP? Or do you prefer to stay away from them and do short to mid-length LPs? Well, we've done Minecraft and Skyrim. I mean, those are both 100+. So I think that counts as long. We've done long LPs, that counts. I prefer to do shorter ones. The reason is the viewer retention is better when the series are shorter. Sort of. It's kind of weird. There's this weird thing that happens. If a series is like really short, like 10 or less episodes, the retention is pretty high. People generally watch those. Oh, that sucks. Sorry. If it's somewhere in the middle, and I don't know the exact number, like 20 to 30, the audience retention is actually like, it kind of decreases. It starts strong, but then just kind of goes down. Whereas if it's short, obviously it starts strong, and because there's not very many episodes, people just kind of keep watching. If it's long, something weird happens. It starts strong, and then after a while, it kind of goes down, and then it comes up again. It's almost like it hits a certain mark where people are like, oh, he's going to be doing this a long time. And then you have these certain amount of people that show up late. We're like episode 80 into Skyrim, and people are like, you know, I just got through watching all the Skyrim episodes so I could catch up. And those are the people that are going to continue to watch. So it's kind of hard to explain that. It's a little weird, but we like doing long stuff, but it's much better to do shorter stuff because you get to knock out more games that way. And it's kind of fun to not have to get, like, stuck on something. With the exception of Skyrim, because Skyrim is still a ton of fun. I like doing that. Love your shirts. We do have shirts. For sale that aren't these. Our shirts are cool. I'm surprised no one's asked where we got them. Or maybe they have. And,
You missed it.
Yeah. Oh, there you go. Steven Mao, where did you get your shirts? These shirts are not available. They were...
You got mine for me for Christmas one year.
They were printed specially by... I think they were printed by Starman. They were printed specially for staff. Because they couldn't... You can't, like, sell them for money. Because you can't profit off of, like, the logos and stuff. So they produced them specifically for the staff of Starman.net. If people wanted them, we could get them. So I got an Earthbound shirt. I actually have two Earthbound shirts. I have another one that's white and has the full logo on it.
The ringer.
And I got the Mother 3 shirt from Al. So. Earthbound, yeah, number one. Saving the world is a ton of fun. When I was talking about shirts for sale, I was talking about the our shirt store, which doesn't have any Earthbound type shirts in it. If you want Earthbound shirts, go to fangamer.com. They don't sell this stuff, obviously, but they have a lot of awesome stuff. So Fangamer's a cool site. What was the inspiration for Greg? Greg is my poor little Bulbasaur. I can't tell you what goes on in my brain. I can't tell you what goes on in my brain. I mean, Greg was one of those things I just kind of sat down and just was like, drew it. So, oh man, for the first time in the entire stream, we dropped below 500 people.
Wow.
Finally, 9:30.
It's
one of those things people are like, okay, probably should get the bed. So, wow, that's awesome. It's not like it's awesome that we're losing people. I mean, I expect to lose people when we're getting to this time of night. It's just impressive that we were able to hold 500 people non-stop since the start of the stream until now. Not until this point have we dropped below 500. That's impressive. That's awesome. Anyway. You're not going to finish this, guys. You should hurry up. Like I said, we're going to finish the game. If we have to be here longer than midnight, we will. But I'm kind of worried that we're not going to finish by then. Someone said, bed at 9:30 on a Saturday? Some people go to sleep late. Also, depending where you are, it could be really late, you know. Steven, will you do an LP of Okami next year? Probably not. Sorry. I'm interested in playing Okami, but there's so many other games on the list. I would venture that 2013 is full. I mean, I don't know what it's full of, but we have enough games that we can pick and choose stuff that it's... You could practically assume that it's full. Have you guys played Super Mario World or Mario 64? Do you know who you're talking to? I love those games. Super Mario World and Super Mario 64 are probably in a tie for my favorite Mario games. And we're definitely doing a Super Mario World LP, and Super Mario 64 LP is very, very high on the consideration list. And we have prize support for Super Mario World. I mean, I know that it's not a real valuable cart, but...
Or rare.
Yeah, or rare, but, I mean, it's just something. What we really ultimately like to do is, as we do Let's Plays of, like, these old retro games, we would like to give away the cards. So, that's something we plan on doing. We're going to be doing a Kirby Dream Land 3
I always wondered if she kisses you with a smack or hits you with a smack.
It's obviously a kiss. Obviously a kiss. What was I saying? Oh, we're going to be doing Kirby Dream Land 3 Let's Play, and we have prize support for that. And that one's kind of a big deal because that's like a $40 cart, but we've had a hold of that for a long time. So, we've been holding it back so we would do a Let's Play with it and give that out as a prize. Probably going to do that real early next year, maybe February or so. So, it's going to be good.
I was already in here and paid $5. $20, really.
God, there's so many things. It's one of those things you have to just jump in and try to read one. Steven, did you eat a lot of Pop-Tarts in college? Yes. And you shouldn't. They're not good for you. They're terrible for you, and I ate too many. People asking me to play Borderlands 2. Chugga visits you guys with you. Will you be thinking of doing a Q&A with him as a special guest? Maybe. I mean, he'd have to agree to that.
Oh, I hate this part. I think it's your turn. I've been playing for a while. Maybe I hate this part because it reminds me of the part in Mother 3 that's similar to this.
This part's way easier than Mother 3.
Yeah. Your turn.
Fine. You deal with questions and such. Part's not bad. There's a lot of cool stuff in here. I think this is where you get the thing that eventually turns into the
thing,
heavy...
The
thing that turns into the heavy bazooka.
Yeah, it is.
What I usually... Is your health full?
No.
What? Why?
Sagan's pushing Kepler off.
Poor Sagan. For Kepler. Is that alive? What is that? There's a broken iron... don't I already have one of these? Yeah, I do. Screw that. I don't even know what that is. My advice for people that are pissed. You have to go the other way, don't you? Aw, dang it. My advice for people doing this dungeon is to don't worry about getting the stuff. Just try to get through and beat the boss, because when you're done, you can get the stuff real easily. That's what I'm going to do, because I know the heavy bazooka's in here, but instead of going around looking for it, I'm going to focus on killing these guys. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god, wow. Paul is dead. I'm gonna have to leave. I'm gonna have to leave. What did you do? You gave me the game and you kept your luck. You didn't give me your luck too. These are easy enemies, but they did a continuous attack which did over 200 damage to Paul right out of the gate. You're not gonna live through that. Whatever. Alright, no problem. And if anyone's wondering if, like, you know, we're not making good progress, we actually are. Not even kidding. We actually are doing pretty good. Going up. Screw you guys. We're going to have to revive Paula. It's going to be in our best interest to do so. We're going to have to pay $20 again to get back into this stupid thing. I think I'm going to go to the hotel. Maybe. Do I need to? Save some money and not. Let's just do. How much HP does Jeff have? Oh, you need 100. And how much do I need? Lots of health. Let's just do this. Alright, let's get get Paula taken care of. We're really going to use her in the sewer. It's a terrible way to start, man. First battle, two roaches, done. I mean, it could be boy crew. We just leave Paula out and be like, we the boys, we gonna do it. But no. You're Montoli, you are not the hospital. Hospital is this way. No whammies, no whammies, no whammies. It's right here. Here we go. Alright, let's do our best here. Paula, please. Paula is dead. Paula's no longer dead. You're dead good. Thank you. Probably getting that time now. I'm just going to start feeling wacky. The rest of the game will just be like, yeah.
And plus now we have tea, so.
Well, fine. Yeah, that'll help at least. Stop making me pay. I was here like a minute ago.
I know, this is like the fourth time.
Alright. Here we go. We're gonna do this so hardcore. Okay. Note to self, head left. No, screw that. Screw you guys. I'm not doing mice and friggin' trash cans. Much better. Okay, head left. Into the water. Now, I can't really say we swim. We're not really swimming. We're kind of mucking. We need to muck. Not to be confused with muck. And you guys knew exactly what I was talking about. Not because I did muck, but because I just did this. Although the muck probably helped. I'm not 100% sure if we get out of the water yet or not. There's a lot of barriers, and it's hard to remember where we get out of the water. I think, actually, we stay in the water pretty much... Oh, piss. We're not getting out of there. I think we stay in the water pretty much the entire time, and then we get right next to the end. Deadly mouse and stinky ghost. Oh, boy. I'm so excited. Let's attack the stinky ghost and hit the deadly mouse with freeze, because freeze is pretty freaking sweet. Kill the deadly mouse real easily. This is not doing a whole lot of damage. Who sucks at attacking until he gets his sword? Let's try fire alpha just so I can test the water here, see if fire is what we need to use. It is. I'll be able to kill him though. Pretty good damage from stinky ghost. Let's just hit it with fire alpha again. Probably kill it, fingers crossed. That was a lot of damage to Pooh. Like, oh god. Oh god, no, 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 no. We gotta kill him now, we gotta kill him now, we gotta kill him now, we gotta kill him now. Pooh's alive. Oh. I thought he was dead. I thought he was dead. That's why I was hurrying. I was like, oh piss, he's dead. Oh, he's not dead. He's fine. Let's do Fire Alpha again. I should have used Beta early on. Don't let the stinky ghost attack. Thank God. Pooh didn't die. A+. Pooh's leveling up like crazy, which is good. Now he's got 5 health. We haven't been possessed. Possession sucks. The only way to get rid of possession is to, how do you get rid of being possessed? The only way to do it is in the Saturn thing.
Sanctuary location.
Yeah, like you have to go to like a... I don't think they can treat that at the hospital, can they? I'm pretty sure they can. Which is bad. Really sucks. Whatever. I'm possessed.
I'll find out!
Let's just go... what is this? What is this bullcrap? What are you? A bug? Filthy attack roach. I'm not gonna let you get the best of me this time. I'm gonna freeze you with Alpha and let everyone else hit you. That was a lot of damage. Everyone is nearly killing Pooh with like every freaking game. That's bullcrap, man. You are so.
Uh-oh, my computer can't handle 4 tabs.
Kill him, Paula. Kill it. Kill it. Kill it. Kill it. Good. I'm relaxed. Pooh's leveling up. Everyone's still really low levels. This might be a pretty low level run. Brain Shock, cool. It's basically confusion. Okay. Alpha that poo. Ew, poo. God, freaking Plague Wrath of Doom is gonna piss me off. I can hardly tell. Just keep going through the muck here.
Someone wants to know our middle names.
Andrew.
Sorry, I was trying to find the possession ghost. My middle name is Gwen.
That's our Test story.
Limits.
Huh?
Crying, dominant, feeling strange, homesick, mastermized, nausea, numb, poison, possessed. Blue-haired healers.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. Well, then never mind. You can do it at the hospital. All right, before I get involved with this, I have a flame pendant. Okay, protection from fire attacks with the knight pendant is from flash, isn't it? Okay. Jeff's wearing the great charm. Might be better to give him the flame pendant, maybe? Not that there's going to be fire attacks coming up. The fire spring, I guess. But it's better than the Great Charm. Just saying. Like, from a defense point of view, it's better. Crap. What else do we got here? Laser gun. Oh yeah, Paula's got a bunch of crap. You never took Paula to the store to get her new stuff. She's using a slingshot? You bought Paula a slingshot.
It flashed?
You don't buy slingshots and you don't buy yo-yos. The accuracy of those weapons is piss poor. You have to buy the frying pans. It's the only thing you're allowed to buy. As soon as we get out of here, we gotta go to the store. I'm surprised we've survived this far. Although, to be fair, Paula uses her psychic ability. She's not known for using her regular attacks. But if you get in a bind, you might need to use it. I'm gonna hit this thing with big ball of rockets as hard as I freaking can. And just kind of hope. I don't think Pooh can even equip the Great Charm, can he?
You've been using slingshots and yo-yos since 3. That's what someone said.
Oh, it actually lowers my defense. Awesome. Pooh hates Western living. I do not want to a Great Charm. That's what he says. Well then, big ball of rockets it is. I'm gonna come out swinging with them as hard as I can, and we'll see what happens. Take a final look at my stats here. I'm feeling alright about this. I would like to increase Pooh's life just a little bit. Oh yeah, that's right.
That might explain the slimy little pile incident.
Yeah, I know. Oh, Mal, I did not know that you bought a slingshot. Also, I realized, as I fed Pooh a pizza, that he hates pizza and can only eat Eastern food. And only get 6 experience, 6 HP out of it. Screw him. Alright, 1 or 2 bugs? 1? 1. Let's just hit this guy fast and hard.
Apparently the game station podcast, did you watch it? Apparently they were making fun of our cat's names and saying you knew nothing about Pokemon.
Really? What? Where is that? I didn't watch the entire podcast. I saw that it was on. I actually didn't watch it at all. But I just saw it was available today. I haven't had time. Making fun of my cat? What? My cats have possibly the coolest names on the face of planet Earth. Just saying. It's absolutely true. Freeze. 2 freezes should be fine. Pokemon names? I didn't know. Why were they discussing that on the podcast? That seems odd. Okay. I think we're set. Let's hope for the best here. The 5th. Your sanctuary location. The good news is as soon as we finish this one, we go straight to the 6th one. So they're back to back. Plague Wrath of Doom. I don't think this guy actually has any shields up. I'm fairly certain he doesn't.
They were making fun of the nothing too bad, though.
Yeah. Okay, let's do Brock and Beta. And Freeze Gamma. And a big ball of rocket. And Freeze Beta. Pooh won't be using his attack, you son of a gun. 200 damage, big ball of rocket, 400 damage, rockin' Beta, we're pounding this guy. 100 damage, and now he took the bite with the poisonous fang. Jeff is freaking dead. Okay, we gotta move. If we get this in, we'll be able to get a big ball of rocket in, which will be really, really useful right now. Go, buddy, go.
Apparently Emile is
Come on, fire it off. Fire it off. Jeff's alive?
Yes.
Oh.
Apparently Emile showed part of her personality pre-op.
Really?
That's what it says.
How is this guy still alive? He showed. I have to watch. I haven't seen the podcast. Well, they're really long. I don't have a whole lot of time to do that anyway, but I will try and see it if I can. This guy is going to be dead in like another hit. There's no way he's going to live through all this stuff. Ness is not going to get to heal Jeff. Ending the battle?
Yeah.
Thumbs up, guys. 28,000. Everyone's alive, so everyone gets to benefit from that, which is awesome. Paul's benefiting. Jeff. Pooh. Pooh again. Pooh three times. Pooh three times. Pooh four times. Oh my god. See a doctor. Pooh four times. We did it. That went pretty smoothly. The next one is a piece of cake. The next sanctuary, like, seriously. We're going to the department store. Like, really gotta go to the department store.
So what's all those wood pieces?
I have no idea.
It's apparently in about the middle of the podcast.
Yeah, if someone knows where that's discussed, because I really don't have time to watch the entire podcast, send me a message or a tweet or something about it that gives like the exact time where I can start watching. I'll watch that part. Not so my babe as well, but just for an instant. Can you guys see my feet? I have like a toe in frame. I'm sorry. Okay, this gives us the carrot key, which is how we access the sixth sanctuary location, which we can do immediately. What we're going to do right now, though, is grab the stuff that we didn't get. What was that?
Oh, look at the babies. Hi, kittens.
Let's get here. Dang it. Here we go. The rats are running away. After you view the sanctuary location, all the enemies in that sanctuary location run. Broken Bazooka, you got it. We're gonna give the Broken Bazooka to Jeff. And he's gonna repair that into the Heavy Bazooka, which is pretty much better than all of his weapons. The downside is you can't just rapidly tap the button to use that. Like, you're gonna have to actually go into his menu and use it, but it's worth it because it will, I mean, it does a pretty good amount of damage. Where's that other door? Hopefully it's not on that side of the
barrier. I think it is, actually.
Is it? And it is... Yeah, it is. What is that, though? Is that worth getting?
That's I don't know. Get the player's guide.
That's not the bazooka. Because I have the bazooka, so I don't even know what that is.
It's the butterfly room, isn't it?
Is it? Oh, there's a butterfly room in here?
Yeah, there's a butterfly
room. You don't need the butterfly room in here. That is... Yeah, you're right, it's a butterfly room. You get any of their stuff is like...
What's in the garbage can?
That's an enemy.
Oh.
Is it? I don't know. No, it's, that's the Rust Promoter DX. The other stuff's not worth getting. The only thing worth getting is the, bazooka. We can leave. Get on the move, because it's 10. Yeah, I'm gonna keep... Bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum. No, we keep going. Because we started on the left, so that's what we're going to do. almost out of the stupid sewer. An exit mouse would have been really awesome, but whatever. Alright, here we go. Up we go, back into Foreside. Well, above ground Foreside. We were technically in Foreside. Did you do Bones Bones?
No.
Where's he at?
That's that guy.
This music? No, Bones Bones is Moonside, isn't it?
Yeah, I didn't do that.
That's lame. Where is it? Where is it in here? It's not in here, it's in... Yeah, there's a guy in Moonside. Then you go to the museum in Moonside, he says, whose bones are on display here? Your bones. My bones. Bones, bones. It's one of my favorite lines in the game. There's another guy in Moonside that says, parking meters? And you're walking around? Ha ha! Moonside. Moonside has some good dialogue. Alright, we gotta take a picture. Apparently, it's just me and Paula. And let's pay a friendly little visit to the department store, because we really have some stuff that we need to get. I mean, there's some stuff we'll have to buy in Scaraba, to be fair, but, why am I using the phone? We're gonna pick up some stuff now. $40,000. And you can actually sell stuff to this person. And we can sell a few things. We don't need the trout. The trout yogurt is pretty useless. We don't need that. Okay. Let's sell some more crap. You are really dancing. We can't sell the chicken. Okay. Anything else? Yes. What do you want to return? We're not going to be able to use the Great Charm, are we? It's not going to do us any good, is it?
Sure.
Do that, yes. Anything else? Yes. Will you return? Oh no, I think that might be it. Yeah, looks good. Okay. Now, while I'm thinking of it, let's give Paula back her crap. Because she is supposed to have some of this stuff. Sorry, Jeff. I just don't give a crap about you. Let's just be honest. I don't. Let's give that to Paula. And, let's equip this stuff. Not that. Platinum band. And coin of defense. Coin of defense. There we go. And I think they sell coin of defense here. Or is that in Summers? But we have to buy our new weapon and a bunch of stuff here, so we're going to be here a while. And probably buy a super plush teddy bear while we're here. They're a pretty good investment. Tool. Is that it? Deluxe fry pan. Chef's fry pan. Silver bracelet. Gold bracelet. Gold bracelet would be good. Right? Yeah, gold bracelet. Because Ness has one, Jeff doesn't have one. So let's give that to Jeff. And equip it. Is there anything else? Yes. Let's sell that silver bracelet, because somebody has that. Yeah, right here. Silver bracelet. Let's get rid of that. Anything else we can do for you? Yes. Buy. Chef's fry pan. For the record, I do know that I haven't given Jeff the coin of silver back. It's because I'm pretty sure someone around here sells the coin of defense. I think. Yes, I want you to buy the slingshot. Oh my god, I almost broke my controller in rage. What else is here? That should be it for that. What do you sell? Cold remedies. You don't sell things that are quite as interesting as that other girl. What floor is this? Sports. We got everything we needed here, I think. Yeah. Jeff could use a baseball cap. What? Why? Because he doesn't have the coin of slumber? Is that it? I think that was it. It's because he didn't have a hat. Yeah, okay. Now he's good. Mm-hmm. He really needed the hat. He was gonna cry. He's like, oh, I don't need a hat. Okay, so here, here's another interesting photo op. There was one time I had my picture taken right here when I just finished up fighting the Mook and Jeff was dead. And it was a picture of Ness and then Jeff's ghost. So now, this should, in theory, have all four people. We did this earlier when we were in front of the gravestone with just Ness and Paula instead of Ness, Paula and Jeff. Something else to pay attention to when we're doing the credits. Let's look at the toys. Trick Yo-Yo. It's flashing, but we will not fall prey to its allure. We're not going to do that. Point of defense for Jeff. Sorry, I'm just saying.
I make good decisions.
Yeah. Yeah, you do. Can I get anything else? Yeah, let's buy a teddy bear. They don't have the super teddy bears here?
Guess not.
They're in Summers. Well, okay. It's gonna be a little bit before we get to,
Someone posted a link to the podcast and said your talk starts at 2:07:50.
Okay.
You wanna open it?
No, because your computer will freak out.
Yeah, just a little.
Thank you for that, because I do want to check it out later. 2:07:50. Appreciate it. I will take a look at it later. For now, I'm going... Is this the right floor? Yes, it is right. Yeah. I'm going to buy a few more Big Baller Rockets and make sure all of, Jeff doesn't have anything he doesn't really need to have. Cup of Life Noodles can be given elsewhere. Like, poo. Ball Rocket, broken crap. I need to get rid of the pencil eraser, so for right now, I'll give it to Paula. Big Ball Rocket, what's a neutralizer do? That resets all of the shields and stuff? But it resets the abilities of all creatures, friend, or enemy to their normal levels. Any changes that had taken place due to PSI and such as neutralized. It also neutralizes all shields that were in effect. Remember, the abilities I'm talking about are offense, defense, guts, etc. It's funny because that description says. What I am talking about, like, there's this mysterious person describing things for us. It's kind of funny. So we can afford to buy 4 Big Baller Rockets, so we'll have 6. I'm okay with that, actually, before I forget. I'm gonna give this stuff to myself, because I like it to be a little neat and orderly. There we go. And now let's buy 4 of these. And it won't be too much longer where we will have the opportunity to buy multis. The first place we're given the opportunity is in Scaraba when we get out of the pyramid. You know what I'm talking about? You get out of the pyramid and you can buy multis. They're $1,000 or $3,000 or something. They pretty much annihilate the enemy. We'll be using that.
Apparently, Emil says, you've never played Pokemon before, and you let fans send in fan art for the LP, which both of which are wrong. See what Lucas said? I like Luke.
What the heck, Emil? Talk about misinformation. Mm-hmm. Jesus. I have definitely played Pokemon before. In fact, in the first he must have not even watched the first episode, which is incredibly sad. In the first episode, I talk about how I put hundreds of hours into the original games and have played the game since then. Not right. I have to talk to him about that. And that's not fan art. It's all art. It's all original art that we did.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you guys could go to the GGS podcast page, like the comments for that video, and correct everything and be like, this is all very wrong, because that is not right. I do not like to spread misinformation. Alright, we're going to call Escargot Express to come pick some crap up. Pick up. Right. We don't need the hieroglyph copy, do we? All that does
is, yeah.
Our pyramid was protected, the invaders were reborn. Even now, the red was time to stab, and place then, man. Only one with the Hawkeye, the Sphinx now watches, the red waited for the coming of Jupiter here. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. basically the star shape starting at the bottom left. We can get rid of that. So we have three things to get rid of. Perfect. Come get my crap. Please. Hello, this is Escargo Express. Your delivery charge is $18. You can cover the bill.
No.
$35,000. We don't need hieroglyph copy. We don't need the laser gun. Curse you, Jeff. And we don't need the pencil eraser anymore. Yep, that's right. Freeing up some space. Sweet. Okay, there's no... I don't think there's any ATMs in DeLong at all. Pretty sure there's not. So we're gonna put a good bit of our money back. Not all of it, but a pretty good amount. Let's keep $1,000, just for the fact that we might want to buy some water or something. Which sounds weird, but I'm completely serious. We might want to buy some water when we get to DeLong. Okay, so things are going good. What do you need? Record. Blah, 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 blah. Alright. Now we're going to go out here and teleport to DeLong. We will buy some water for Pooh, I think. As I teleport to DeLong.
Can you move a little bit? I'm warm. Am I
good?
Yeah.
Okay. Now we'll just go ahead and head down. Mm-hmm. One of these is the shop, but it has a sign in front of it, I think, so we can tell.
Mm-hmm.
Not that. Is it this one? It's not that one. Is it this one? No. It's this one! We should buy the right screw on those sorts of things. Those sorts of things. Let's get some bottled water. Bottled water restores 20 PP, but only for poo. It's very useful to stock up on these and give them to poo. Makes it much easier. Then you just let Pooh do a lot of psychic stuff all the time. Especially because his weapons, you're not going to get the sword. You're probably not going to get the Sword of Kings. So we'll just let him do a lot of psychic stuff, and he'll always be able to refill it really easily. Basically like a piece of caramel, except they only cost $4, which is pretty great. No, let's see here. Let's give that to himself. That to himself. I think we're good. We have a lot of bottles of water there. Like, we really don't need that many. Everybody's looking really good right now. I'm pretty impressed. We shouldn't have any problems at all. Let's do it. We should probably save up in the castle thing, but sure. Not worried.
When you die.
I'm not worried. I'm just not worried. Everything's gonna be great. The music in this cave is awesome. Thought he was gonna get me. Is there always a guy there? Because that sucks. Run for it. Got it. Going up. Two enemies. Tangu, is that their name? Tangu and Thundermite. You can usually bash your way through this pretty easily. I know as soon as I say that, I'll regret it. Also, notice how Paula actually hit the enemy. And she didn't get her slingshot out and completely messed with that. She's taking heavy damage. Oh, good! Everybody's asleep. I may regret not just bashing, like, not using, like, such moves. Oh, piss!
Oh, someone's in trouble.
Nessus is asleep during this entire thing. Well, now, I'm not gonna say I did anything wrong, but... I walked in, I'm like, nah, I don't think we need to do anything. We just bash these guys. Oh, I found a snake. Good thing Ness took it. There's gonna be an enemy down there.
Nope, you're lucky.
My god. Whatever. Whatever. No problem. No problem. Easy peasy. This will be a good picture. This will be a good picture. Ness and Jeff alive. The other guy's dead. Alright, excellent photo op right here. I'm pretty sure that when we talk to this guy, he automatically refills everyone's health. He has to. He'd have to, because otherwise how would you get out of here? If Ness was dead, it'd be impossible. That's a very close together photo op, less than 30 seconds away.
It's the same with the dinosaur inside the museum, but in the seven steps.
I guess maybe at the end they're like, shove these photo ops in. I mean, I know I've said this several times already, but like, there's so many times where, you know, you're thinking like, man, even all these little details that they had. Also, since I'm here, I was probably a good idea. 44,000 in the bank. We're still pretty low level. Originally, because at the beginning of the playthrough we were pretty high level. Now we're not that high anymore. I think we're pretty low. Who's still in the 20s? Let's go back in here and kick some tail. Bring it on. I can take out one enemy. I can do one. Tengu. Alright. Here's what we're gonna do. Who? Freeze that son of a gun. Hit him hard. Freeze him. Okay. Now remember, kids, who got all that water? I just saw this song. Who drinks water to refill his pee-pee, and his name is Pooh. Mature. Let's head up here and try to get this over with. The only thing I'm not real excited about is the fire spring. That's one of the only parts of the game I really loathe. Do not like that. I'm gonna attack the Thundermite, I think. And have Pooh use Freeze Beta on the Tengu. Because the Thundermite's kind of a pain in the butt. Yes! Reflect that stupid lightning. Don't hit Wally. Good. That's down. Hit the Tengu. Tengu makes me fall asleep. Doesn't matter. I will freeze it. And we made it through this battle alive. I thought we did. Kill it, dang it! Friggin' hit him! Thank you, Jeff. Jeff, my only friend. Everyone levels up. Well, two guys level up. Let's get Pooh to use life up on Paula. There we go. Keep moving. We're trucking. Random one here. Don't let the other one wander in. Crap. Let's take out the Thundermite, honestly. I don't think Freeze is gonna work good on the Thundermite. I just have this feeling it will. Maybe it will. Screw it. Thundermite. Thundermite's the worst. The other guy just makes you go to sleep. This guy actually hits you with big attacks. Thundermite's actually kind of a problem. Freeze Beta? Holy piss! I was completely wrong. That is a wonderful attack to use. I am going to hit him. Paula, you use Freeze Beta. Shoot this guy, and if you get a chance to do anything, you will Paula. Excellent. Satisfied. Just want to get this stupid thing. Snake! Snake!
What's after this?
Scaraba.
Am I doing that?
Yeah, you can do that if you want. Let's use
Life Up on Paula.
Use life up on Paula. You were right! And then let's use Pooh's life up on Pooh. Pretty good. Hole! Oh, heck yeah. Friggin' butterfly. Sudden guts pill. Alright. I want to attack these guys, and I want that butterfly to stay there. Double Tengu. Interesting. Have these guys hit this one, and these guys hit this one. Freeze baited one. Freeze baited to the other. Ooh, Paula's got your beat, Pooh. Paula fell asleep, but she'd already attacked. Pooh fell asleep, but he'd already attacked. Haha, you idiot. I only managed to get one. Ness and Jeff hit that one. It should be over real quick. Excellent. That was a smooth battle. At least compared to the other ones. Like when we first wandered into this dungeon and lost pretty much everybody. Pooh's level's now 30. Cool. Let's see here. Now, I haven't used any of my stuff. I could give everyone a boost. Let's give Pooh and myself a boost. So let's do that real quick. There we go. Let's grab this stupid thing before it gets away. It's going to give us 20 extra, which will refill Ness's back to full. And Pooh's is not quite back to full, but you know, he'll live. We have to take the far hole, right?
Yeah.
Whee! Hi, guys! How's it going? So shiny. Conducting Menace. Yay, we got some. Let's use Rock and Beta and see if we can help maybe get this over with as fast as possible. I don't think fire is actually what we want to use here, but I'm going to try it anyway. Just because I'd rather try and hit both enemies at the same time if I can. You... Thunder on Thunder probably is not good. Freeze one, see what happens. Fire on these guys. Fairly effective.
Yeah.
Thunder Alpha. Flash Beta. Not, that could be bad. That could be bad. I would rather people cry. That move can kill you instantly. Flash is a crazy move that can do a lot of moves. Got one down. That's cool. And they're not going to be able to do anything. Let's hit this with Freeze Beta. Defend, defend. Freeze it, and we should be good. Why are you tickling my foot?
He's telling you to put your foot down.
Oh. Sorry. I'm comfortable, dang it. Okay, is that better? I think so. Hashtag, everyone's alive. Hallelujah. Okay. 7,000. Paula's leveling up. That's good. Paula learned Fire Gamma. Sweet. Okay. What's that? Rock Candy! You can do a rock candy trick and have crazy, crazy stats, but that makes the game cheap. Let's do life up. Life up. And I'm letting Ness handle it for now in case we run into another magic butterfly. And also, I have plenty of health, so. Looking good. Looking really good. I'm happy about this. Now, we had left and killed you guys and we come back and jump through the hole, right? I'm pretty sure. I'm fairly certain. Let's try our newfound Freeze Gamma, which is gonna mess some people. Oh, we got Fire Gamma. We've had Freeze Gamma. Let's use that on this guy. Die, piece of crap. Maybe that'll kill him. Not quite. Hopefully this guy won't do too... Oh, Thunder Bay, the fist. 198. Okay, we're good. Get bash him to death. 18, that's not helpful. 61, way more helpful. Oh, piss, he got in Flash Beta. Did not work. Just while he came numb. That's better. Oh, what a tangled web we weave when first we practice to do nothing but bash. Who's leveling up? Jeff's gonna continue to be numb. We're gonna have to fix that. I think Healing Beta will fix that. Really? Really? Pooh, do you know some kind of... No.
Nope.
It's the higher level one, isn't it?
Yep.
Okay. Alright. That really sucks, but it's not a huge problem. it's bad, but it's not like the end of the world. We can get by without using his bottle rockets. There it is. Okay, we can do this. Should be able to get through this pretty quickly. Before we start, let's use a bottle of water. One, two. Oh, they recover 10, not 20. Sip them down, Pooh. Sip them down. You're gonna be using some attacks.
Oops. You want me to fight them?
What? No, this is easy. These guys fall like crazy to freeze. Like, freeze them and, oh, it's done. So that's what we'll do. I'll bash him. Freeze Gamma. Bye. And freeze Beta. This battle will be over really quick. Nearly 400 and they're solidified. No damage. Offense, defense, vulnerable to flash, actually. Try flash. Okay. Ness. Flash Beta. And he might not get a chance to attack because freeze might kill them. Can you spy twice? Does that do anything?
No, it's just the same thing.
This will probably kill them. Or not. Flash Beta. Felt a little strange. Taking a deep breath for the next assault. They'll never get a chance. Or maybe they will. I'm gonna hit them with flash again. This is fun. They probably won't live past this, though. I imagine there's no way they're gonna continue to live. Freeze? They're still alive. I'm amazed. There they are. No! I should probably stop wasting this in case something goes terribly wrong, but I have so much friggin' TP for Paula, like, nothing's gonna happen here. Everything's going great. Just freeze, 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 freeze. There we go.
There you go.
It's like 400 damage every time.
Here. Huh.
Take it?
Yeah. I'm warm.
Oh, you're gonna play because you're warm?
Yes.
Alright. See, it's funny because I was just thinking how cold it was in here. I guess you don't feel the same.
No, I don't.
Everyone levels up. Hot dang.
Aku learned that move.
Awesome. That'll be useful on the Kraken, which you'll have to fight very soon. Okay. Have you two ever played Team Fortress 2? I bought Team Fortress 2 shortly after it came out, actually. When the Orange Box came out, I had it. And it was fun back then. It's not that it's not fun now, it's just that I tried to play it recently and it's so much has changed. I'm like, I don't know what's going on. So, now, Paula, why would you take that? Someone left a very long-winded comment on the TGS podcast. I mean, I haven't seen the podcast myself. I don't know if this was required. I'm sure that it was in good taste. You don't need to post all of this. It's like a list of 10 points about how they don't have the right to do this or that. It's not really necessary to do that.
Now do I go to Scrabble?
I know that they're misinformed, and you can let them know that they're misinformed, but you don't have to be like, you have no place to do this or that. Like, yeah, it's, we're trying to keep a fairly good reputation, for the record. It wasn't in good taste. Well, I'll have to look at the podcast. So. Where are you going?
Since I go to Scrubba now?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
How it feels to walk Myrtle Beach. been so long. You know I'm right. Is this where I get stuff that's cheap?
There's a shop.
Is it the one that says shop above it?
Yep. Probably not that guy's house. Probably the shop.
Kitty! Yep. It's a hissing kitty.
This is not the shop. This is the wrong shop. This is not the shop that sells the... You know what? You only... How much of money you have on you? No, that's fine. Just... You could probably head straight to Scarabum now. Honestly. I don't think you really need anything. Most of the stuff that you would need, you could get in Scarabum. I say just go. You'll be alright. Probably. If there's anything you really need, you can get it later.
Yeah. And then I gotta teleport. Wish I could steer the boat. And how come this boat's different from all the other boats?
It's a special boat.
Well, then why bother to make it different? You already got one boat.
To make it special.
I don't care what.
I've never noticed it was different, so.
It has a flag and it sits lower in the water and it's rounder. It doesn't have pink on it. And the windows are white, not blue. Wait, I want to go to that island. Drop me off. How about that island? There's something there.
There is stuff there. I don't know why you can't visit it. That's sad. We've had a few more donations. We're currently at, excuse me, $1,112. $222 of the goal, which is amazing. Stephanie Macklin donated and says, congrats on exceeding your donation goal. I wish you and Mal all the best in your life and future endeavors. Happy thoughts. And Aaron Williams says, meow!
He's
just
sleeping.
For.
He's just paws like this and he's just asleep.
He is very cute. My meow probably did not. What? This is easy. Just use freeze like crazy. You're gonna have to recover anyway, so just use all your powerful freeze attacks and you'll get through it in like no time. Peace cake. Bam. Plus, when he solidifies, he's not gonna hurt you. Kraken's only got 1,000, like 1,000 to 1,500 or something. It's not that much. Kraken was able to move! Yeah, you got this.
There we go.
Freeze him again. Solidify. Nope. Nope. Freeze the fire! Who's got the flame pendant? Jeff? Yeah, Jeff took 12 damage. Jeff's like, what's wrong with you guys? I got this flame pendant. He's gone. Yes. Very nice. Breathing fire is a big deal. Cool. Everyone lived. Nice. Someone says, Steven, are you tired? I am tired. I'm not gonna lie. I'm tired. I went to bed late. Two nights ago, and pretty late last night, so I haven't had a full night's rest in a while, and there's still a lot. There's a Pokemon episode that was supposed to come out tomorrow, and I rescheduled that to come out on Monday, because I don't have it done, I won't have it done, so we're having an episode of Donkey Kong come out tomorrow, and that one's actually not edited, so when the stream ends, I'll have to edit that to come out tomorrow, so that'll come out tomorrow. I almost said it was kind of nice to have a break for today, because a video didn't come out today, but we're streaming for like 15 hours or something straight, so I guess it's not the same as a break. You're gonna go look at the poop? Pokey stink still hangs in the air. You guys can see that? Pokey pooped in the desert. Chubby Kid did his business here. Such a fantastic game. The best games feature large children pooping in deserts. Let's see. Someone says, are you ever going to Indiana anytime soon? For any reason? We go through Indiana every, well, not every summer, but...
Whenever we go to Wisconsin.
When we go to Wisconsin, we go through Indiana. I have a friend, Chaz, who lives in Indiana, so we drive through it. Otherwise, not really. It's not a common occurrence.
Hey, will you play for, like, a minute so I can go to the restroom?
I'll play for...
Also, I don't know what to get, so I'll let you do that.
Where's the... Was that the store?
That was a store, but it wasn't any items that you need.
Oh, it
was
wasn't...
like, wet towels and stuff.
Oh, okay. So many photo ops, man. Let's see. Steven Mao, have you guys played Mario Party DS? Yeah, we have. I've played it in the past, and it's very fun. Did we take the picture yet? Do you hope Mother 3 will be localized in the U.S.? That's a good question, but it won't. I mean, it's not even a hope. It's like, that won't happen. Like, that will not happen. Unfortunately. I thought this guy sold me stuff. I can't talk to the camel. It makes me sad. One of these people sells something good, right? Yeah, this guy. This guy sells Platinum Bands. It's basically the same crap that you can buy in, Summers, but for way reduced prices. So it's kind of picking up. Crystal Charm. Broken Cannon. So we will buy a Big League Bat and a Platinum Bat. We're going to need some money. Which we can get from the hotel. Which still has the hotel sign in front of it. And we probably need to rest. Which we definitely do. We only have the really, really nice one available. So it's like $400. Okay. Oh, and the arms dealer's in here, that's right. More Big Baller Rockets. I think we, I don't think we've even used them, have we? Huh, we're good. What do you got? Oh, the guy that reads stuff. Kraken is gone forever. What's that say? Well, there is some news here about... He never continued. That's weird. I don't know if I've ever really noticed that before. Alright, let's do withdrawal. And get... like a good $20,000 to buy all these Platinum Bands. Which we won't give to Pooh, because he doesn't like them. He thinks they're icky. Here we go. Big League Bat. Let's sell the snakes, I guess. And the sudden guts pills. Use the rock candy, it's basically a stat increase. Otherwise, I don't really need to sell anything else. Picnic lunch. Yes. Fantastic. Let's sell the snake. That's a lot of money for a snake. Same as a chicken. Let's sell the other snake. I'd say it's worth $110. What snake is that? Sell. Sudden guts bill. We never freaking use these. Let's use the rock candy so it's out of our inventory. We'll just use it on this. Got one up I want. That's fine. Now let's buy crap. Rock candy randomly increases a stat by one. There's a trick that you can use with rock candy in battle if you fill up your inventory with condiments or something. And it uses the condiment and not the rock candy. Which is pretty neat. Is there anything listed you might want? Buy. The friggin' bat. Okay. Got the bat. Okay, excellent. Is there anything else you can get? Yes. Platinum band. Platinum band. Buy the gold bracelet. Yes. Buy. Platinum band. Platinum band, you say? Yes, I do say. Platinum band. Ah, you farting. Alright, I gotta sell the gold bracelet. Is there anything else I can do? Yes. What will it be? Sell. What do you want to sell? I want to sell Jeff's gold bracelet. Gold bracelet? It's worth this much. What do you say? Okay. Yes. Will I buy? Yes. I want to buy a platinum band. Platinum band for Jeff. Thank you. Will this go to Jeff now? Thank you. You want to equip it? Sure do. Alright, 40 extra points. You want to do anything else? Yeah, what do you want? I'm going to do the friggin' crystal charm. Crystal charm, you say? Who do you want this to be? I want this to be Paula. Paula, you want to do that? Yeah, okay, bro. $200 great charm. Sounds good. Great. Anything else you can do? No.
Okay. You done?
I think. I'm not sure. Piggy noses are useful later, but screw it. I don't want the snake sack. You are afraid of snakes. What do you do? Oh, you sell, this crap. You sell garbage. Put your money back. Just go put your money back, because you have a pissload of money. But then, proceed. Alright.
Talk to this guy?
Yeah, you don't need anything by him. Because he's got the big bubble rockets, and we already have a full inventory of them.
Okay.
On-screen chat is frozen.
Pokemon.
It's the end of times. Colloquy, yeah, Colloquy could have freaked out. Hold on. I can do this. I can fix it. 1 second. Alright, is it working?
Red caterpillar?
Okay, I fixed it.
No caterpillar.
I'm the fixer. Okay, give me this back. We are gonna freaking beat Earth back. 8 hours? No, I'm a liar. 9 hours? No, I'm a liar. 10 at most?
Caterpillar.
Liar. Going into,
No caterpillar.
11 hours now. For reasons of mouth trying to fight caterpillars. I mean, you can fight the caterpillars here are worth a ton.
I know.
So.
I want a caterpillar. I want a capillator.
I want a capillary. I want a castrator. I want a...
There's... No, it's not one, but... Okay.
I like how you shoved Pooh out in front of Pooh. Deal with this. He's like, oh, what? Okay. Like, I've never been here before. He's a great Preston.
He's
For the record, I saw Genderbender Ness. Nessa. She doesn't have a leg. Or an ankle. Maybe she's digital. Because she's like melting away into what looks like pixels.
Fine, I won't fight a Kappa later.
She looks good though. Good job.
Sagan stretching like a kitty.
We might LP Halo 4. Right after we finish LPing Halo 2 and Halo 3, I will do them in order. I'm in no rush to do them. So.
Have my tea.
There we go.
Thanks.
Oh, crap.
Huh.
Having those bottles would have been nice. Would have made the thing a lot easier, the pyramid.
I'm really not worried about it.
Okay, no problem. Don't worry about it. That's fine. You're not really in frame. I mean, you kind of are.
I'm good. I'm comfy.
You want to lean on two of these so you're closer to me?
Sure. Mm. I thought you were hugging me.
No, I don't hug. I don't do hugs. Ow! Oh, that's a good question. Steven, do you still have your original save file from when you were a kid? Yeah, I do. I do. The cart has not lost its save file. Actually...
The Sphinx Pyramid looks sort of like Facade.
A lot of Super Nintendo games, even though they are old, their batteries still work. I've noticed N64 games still work. Game Boy games still work. I've had so much trouble with Game Boy Color games. Don't know why. Game Boy Color games just don't keep it. Bottom left.
I know.
You got it. Pokemon Red, Blue, and Yellow. All the save files are still there. My Pokemon Gold and Silver. Nope. Gone.
What?
So, I don't know what's up with that.
We're looking for the hot guy.
I'm not a big fan of this place.
I actually really like it.
Really?
Uh-huh.
How about it?
There's a comic somewhere on StarMyNetNet that's making fun of the hot guy. I was like, we gotta pick a hot guy. I should kill him all.
Someone just asked if we'll ever have a meetup.
Oh,
yeah, we could do
know.
That! Bye, Paula. Yeah, you're not.
Great. Great.
I'm telling you, I get cocky with Bash. I do. I get cocky where I'm like, oh, you know, we can bash this guy. As soon as I start bashing him, he kills someone. And I'm like... So my advice is to utilize your items, your psychic abilities, because you'll die. You'll freaking die. Make sure you got your health under control. Let's see here. Starweb says, I can't seem to time it right for you to see my question. When I see stuff like that, that's when I, like, try to, like, go against the flow like a salmon to try and find the question. So now I'll scroll up and see if I can find it.
Lethal ask.
Steven, are you still going to make a Minecraft server for your fans? That was the question. It was one of those, like, ultimate dreams that I don't think will ever come to fruition. Sadly. It's something I've always wanted to do. I think it would be fun to do, but I don't think it'll probably happen. I have no idea. I mean, the biggest problem was money, because we would have to like buy a server and have it set up for people to play on, because I couldn't run it on my own computer, because I need my computer to do other stuff, and I'd have to always be restarting it and stuff. It would be kind of annoying. So it's something I would like to do, but... I don't really have a way to do it, because Minecraft servers and stuff can be very expensive. So, maybe in the future is basically my best answer.
I'm owning this pyramid.
Someone says, do you recommend replacing the battery in the cart, or is that something I shouldn't risk? I personally have never replaced a battery in a cart before.
I could do it.
But I've looked at guides and stuff online for it, and it doesn't seem that difficult.
I can solder.
If you can solder it, you should be fine. You can also get away with like taping it or something, but solder is supposed to be the way you're supposed to do it. But, I mean, I don't know. It's kind of a weird situation, because Earthbound is such a valuable game, and a lot of people don't want to touch the innards of it. But people like them to work. It's kind of like an old car, you know? Like, you want the old car to run. You know, you don't want it to just sit there. So if you can get it to work, that'd be awesome, but it's not really, like, a requirement. I don't know. It's up to you. If you want to practice, maybe you should practice on, like, a more common game. Like, try to buy a Super Nintendo game that's real cheap and replace it yourself, and then if you get it down, then try Earthbound. I would recommend that, personally. Because Earthbound, you don't want to mess it up. So, anyway. I just saw Thorix art. It says, please, kill me. And it's the actual sprites in the game. Very, very nice. We've had quite a bit of fan art. I should have been asking for more fan art throughout the night. You guys probably would have made it. I didn't really think about that, but that was pretty hilarious. I like that. Please kill me.
Mummy wrap.
And you know, that feels like forever ago.
Mm-hmm. God. What heals colds?
Healing Alpha.
Okay.
You could tweet your questions, but I don't have Twitter pulled up right now. And Mallory's laptop is not very good. Like, if you have multiple tabs open, the laptop just kind of dies. Desert Wolf fan art. Yeah, sign me up. I do have my Super Nintendo from childhood. All of my original systems from childhood, I still have. They're still in good condition, and they all still function. Although my N64 has acted a little funny lately. I don't know. Sometimes you go to make it work, and it just doesn't quite work exactly like you want it to. I guess. I don't know. I might need to open it up and clean it or something.
Good job, Ness. Beautiful battle, except the
Red Swirl. I do not watch Doctor Who, but Mal does.
I've tried to get Steven to watch, like, an episode of it and sit down on the couch with me and watch it, but he's like, I've seen enough of you watching it to know what goes on.
I have. I mean, like, I've watched Mal watch it at a computer. Sometimes she doesn't wear headphones, and I've, like, watched parts of it. I've probably watched, like, 2 or 3 hours of Doctor Who just in little pieces that I've watched from her, and I don't know. I mean, it seems like a pretty cool show, but I don't watch a whole lot of TV, so. What was the name of the shelter you got Sagan and Kepler? It was a place called Cattails, and it's in
North Carolina.
Sunset Beach? Or Ocean Isle Beach?
Ocean Isle, I think.
I think it's in Ocean Isle Beach, North Carolina. It's like right over the line. We do not watch The Office. Here's my fan art since you didn't see it. Oh, I did see it. I just said I saw that. I did in fact see that fan art. I might have to take out my contacts soon. My eyes are getting...
It helped. Yeah,
I know it does. Do you think Valve will actually release Half-Life 3? Yeah, of course. It's such a big... it's a big series for them. Well, they make money off of it. It's one of those situations anytime people are like, oh, they're not going to make another this game, they're not going to make another that game. And I'm like, well, did the other game sell incredibly well and make them a pissload of money? And they're like, well, yeah. And then, like, then they will. I mean, when Halo ended, in Halo 3... That was obviously not the end of the Halo series. They made a bunch of spin-offs, and then finally they got around to making a new trilogy because it makes so much money. So, I mean, it's the same deal. I mean, if there's money to be made, there's always going to be more games. So, you know it's going to happen. Half-Life is such a huge series. It'll happen. Half-Life 3 will come out. I don't know when, but it'll happen. Even if it was garbage, it would sell. Because people are so excited for it, because they've been waiting on it for so long.
Dang it.
You wasted.
Yeah.
Pyramid's hard, man.
No, it's not.
It is.
You keep catching colds.
I think it's hard, because you're going to have to fight the big guy. You also lose poo right at the end, so make sure that he doesn't have anything you need.
Yeah, remind me before I walk out.
Alright.
Hi, Cap. They've been sleeping a lot lately.
We might be giving him too much food. We might have to cut back.
I think we should.
Because they used to be crazy like 50% of the time. Now they're crazy like 20% of the time. They got Evan vomiting, which is good. Someone says, what is Doctor Who, Mal? It's a show. It's been on for a long time.
50 years. I think they're having their 50th anniversary this year.
It's been on for 50 years.
Well,
so very
it was off the air for a while.
Yeah, they remade it.
Yeah, they restarted it a couple years ago on BBC.
Just go to Google and type in Doctor Who and look at the Wikipedia article on it.
It's good.
You can do that for anything you want to know about. Joe Bob says, do you know my username? I do know your username. Steven, you have exactly an hour and 11 minutes left. Knowing how much we have left to get through... We have to get through the rest of this. If Mal doesn't die, if Mal dies, we have to go through all of it again.
I'm not dying.
Good luck. And then we have to go through Dungeon Man. Twice, almost.
Good boy, Cap.
What comes after... After Dungeon Man is going to be, Lost Under... Or the... Deep Darkness. Ooh, God. Oh, God. I'm getting worried. Dungeon Man, Deep Darkness. We go to the Tenda Village. Then we have to do the underground base for Stonehenge.
Uh-huh.
We're not stopping until we finish Earthbound.
Yeah.
But I'm realizing that. Wow. Okay. Just to recap for everyone, even if you haven't played Earthbound, let me just kind of break it down for you where we're at. When Mal finishes this, she's got to do Dungeon Man. Dungeon Man's not incredibly long. It's pretty easy. There's not a whole lot of enemies. Should get through that pretty quickly. Then she has to go through Dungeon Man again. It usually goes faster the second time. Sort of.
Is there anything special with him?
I think Freeze. But I generally use Freeze for, like, everything. So if I'm wrong, he'll know real quick. Use a Big Bother Rocket! You have like a full inventory of them. Did you use Mirror?
Okay, no, I used
Freeze. Did you use Big Bother Rocket? Because you have so many.
Thanks, Jeff.
Jeff got in a spy before he died. You had no idea you used Big Bother Rocket. That's odd. Anyway, what was I saying? Dungeon Man twice, although that's pretty short. That's not a big deal. Deep Darkness, which is going to take us a little while to get through. Not real excited about that. When we get through that, we get to the Tenda Village, and then we immediately have to go to Winters to go through the base, the Stonehenge base. Then we leave there and go back to Tenda Village and go through the 7th dungeon to get the 7th sanctuary location. Then we wander around in Lost Underworld for a while, talk to a magic rock, go into the Fire Springs, beat the Fire Springs. When we beat the Fire Springs, we're transported to Magicant. When we finish Magicant, we come to and we go to Southern Valley. From Southern Valley, we have to go back to Onnit and get the Meteotite from the Meteorite. Once we finish that, oh my god, then we have a lot to do. Then we go back to Southern Valley, we head to the Cave of the Past, and we beat the game. We will not be done in an hour. At all. Hey! Where's he at? There's a cat over there, dang it. Where are you at, cat? Cat?
Where's the cat?
Cat? Oh, the cat's down there. No cat. Bad cat. Sagan, why don't you come up here and chill with us? I think the cats are probably more confused than anything that we're... Like, why we're over here.
We've been on the couch all day.
Yeah, they're like, these stupid humans are lazy.
And they've been sleeping all day.
Come here, bud. Come here. We're not lazy, we're raising money for charity, kitties. Speaking of which, let's check in. I have a feeling most of the donations have probably slowed down, which is understandable. That's fine. I'm glad we got over 1,100. I thought that was awesome. 225% of the goal. We are at 1124, and the newest donator is Carlos Tercios, donated and said, it's not much, but it's for a good cause. Absolutely, Carlos, thank you so much. And, once again, very impressed. $1,124. And I am getting tired, but we're gonna beat this freaking game. Anyway.
Samantha Black. Oh, I know that name.
Someone says you better get the Sword of Kings. No! No. You are. No. That. No. No. We're not doing that. No. I mean, it could happen. I mean, we could possibly run into the Sword of Kings and get it, but we're not gonna search for it. Come up here. Do it. Come here, kiddies. I'm about to get one.
Which one?
Second. Might get Kepler too. Come here, buddy.
Rain pendant.
There's one. Come here. I attracted him with a pen. I has kitten. Oh god, hi kitten. What?
You scared kitten.
No, he sniffed your laptop and freaked out. Maybe it shocked him.
Maybe.
I'm sorry, kitten. Laptops generally don't do that, but if it prevent you from chewing wires, I would be a-okay with that. I have to keep an eye on Sagan because he's the wire chewer, and he'll do it right, like right out of my eyesight so I can't see him. I'm watching you. With my stupid bag. Why are you chewing my bag? No. We're not doing this. We're moving this bag. Ah, how do you like that? Now it's moved. Okay. Alrighty. I went to adjust my glasses. Oh, it's been a long day. I was like, oh, there's nothing here. You guys don't need to chew my bag up. Like, it's really not a requirement. I'm gonna put it up here with me. That way, if you want to chew it, you have to at least be near me so I can hit you. Still 500 people, my god. Heading into 11 o'clock. I have heard of the Persona series. I also know that it's very long, and I don't have a whole lot of free time anymore. So, it's probably a series I won't get into. It's a game I'd like to try, it's just... I don't know if I'm ever gonna have time to try it. Everyone says that they want us to kiss at the end of the stream. Aw, that's sweet. Play the Songstone and vlog. How much time do you have left, Steven? We have as much time as we need to finish, the game. Extra Life kindly requests that everyone try to do 24 hours from noon to noon. We can't do 24 hours, like, we have to go to bed, but we are also going to, we want to make sure that we do finish the game, so if we have to be up a few extra hours to finish it, we will finish it. We're gonna finish it now, in one sitting. Which I've never done. I've never done that before. If I have, I don't remember doing it. Did you get the... or you hit the button?
Yeah, on the way up.
You got some PSI caramels if you want to heal the other guys. Or do you have an item for it? Ah! Yeah, use that on Pooh and heal... heal your own stuffy nose, Pooh. Alright. How can you play a game this long?
It's easy because we're switching. No, don't kill Jeff.
It was odd how the last Nintendo Speaks asked everyone to contribute to a contest thing. I don't even remember doing that. Do you know what Toohoo is? I do not know what Toohoo is. Do you?
No.
Is your Xbox really hot from playing for this long? Probably. I hope the fans are good. I hope everything is okay. Because that would be bad if it overheated. I need that to continue working. We would be in trouble if the Xbox stopped working. Do you drink coffee / tea / energy drinks to stay awake? We drink coffee from time to time, never energy drinks, and we drink a lot of tea. We have sweet tea right now, sweet black tea. We drink a lot of other tea, like Earl Grey, Irish breakfast tea, things like that. Juhu is a bullet hell game from what I've heard. I've heard of that, I think. I've heard the name, I just didn't know what it was. Steven, could you lower the slow mode time by just a bit? What's it at now? 30?
45.
Is that 45? Apparently it was at 45. I changed it back to 30. Probably helps. Someone says, wait, Earthbound on Xbox? Emulator much? Yeah, we are playing Earthbound on an emulator. We have Super Nintendo. Actually, at the moment we have three. we have two. I'm going to be selling two probably tomorrow if I get a chance. Take it to a local game store. But I do have my childhood one. We have several copies of Earthbound, actually. We collect them because we're really big Earthbound people. But as far as streaming goes, as far as like quality and ease of recording, you can't be using an emulator. So that's why we use an emulator, because it makes the most sense from a quality standpoint. So we could use Super Nintendo, but it's not going to look like this. It will not look as good.
What is your poison?
Poison? Beta? It requires beta. Do you remember the time Alex chased you down the dorm hallway yelling, "What do you think?" Yes, that will be something I never forget.
The Hawkeye!
Did I answer your question if it is not too much trouble? Well, I have to scroll up and figure out what that question is. Feel the Xbox. Is that what you want me to do? Yeah, okay. I can't scroll up any higher than that. I'm sure it's fine. It hasn't overheated. I mean, I think the original Xbox probably had proper cooling. Not to mention that I can't imagine that running like a Super Nintendo emulator is all that taxing. I am interested in doing a Sims LP. It's actually on the list. Hold on. Let me put this in here. You guys will appreciate this. I'm typing a link into the chat right now. And there it is. I did it under Mel's name. But if you click that, it shows you the video games that we are interested in possibly doing in the near future.
Dang it.
I have never played any of the Ratchet & Clank games. Someone just straight up asked, how are we tonight? We are doing great. We have raised over $1,100 for a children's hospital, and I'm feeling pretty great about it. I did not think that we were going to raise anywhere near that much. So I feel good. I was hoping for $500, and we more than doubled that, so I feel really good about it. I am a little tired. I thought for sure that we would have finished Earthbound by now. I did not anticipate the problems that we would run into, because we definitely ran into some issues. Earthbound should at most take you like 9 hours, and I was thinking we would beat it in probably 8, and we didn't. So
what happens if Pooh is dead when he's supposed to leave?
When you go to leave. The guy swoops down, he says, "It's nice to meet you," and as soon as he does, everyone has full health. Yeah. But Pooh not being alive sucks.
Yeah, look at it.
Do you know what Warhammer 40,000 is? I do. I've never played, and it seems really freaking expensive. Steve and I have Windows, and I have a Mac mouse. See, actually, I hate Mac mice. I don't like the fact that there isn't two buttons. I mean, there is two buttons, but there's not two physical buttons. It makes it very hard to play certain games, unless they've changed the design of their mice recently. I know that, like, my friend Dan, he had a Mac mouse, and it was just like impossible for him to play. Just get a actual third-party mouse, because you need two physical buttons to play certain games. Well, thanks. Why do you plan on playing Sims 3? I don't see how you can make an LP of that interesting. Well, since you are being honest, it's an idea I've actually thrown around for a while. It's I don't think it's gonna be as boring as you think. It's something that we'll try. It's something I cat's attacking my hand. It's something I'd like to try once Skyrim ends. And my idea for it is the same concept as Skyrim, one episode at a time. Very much user input. Very much user input. I'm thinking that the beginning of the LP, there would be a video that says, like, the LP's gonna be coming out. And before the first episode comes out, I'd make a video that basically would ask you to describe a person. Name them. What are their traits? What are they like? What are their aspirations, their goals, stuff like that. And then I would look through those comments, and I might choose one or two, and I would make these people in the neighborhood. And every episode, they'd be recorded one at a time, so they'd be 3 days apart. And so it'd be the same concept as Skyrim, and people would be able to say, you know, I really like what this character's doing. You should try and make him focus on this. And in the individual households, the episodes, it might only take a few episodes to complete someone's life, but I think it would be interesting. It'd be heavily user inputted. You know, if someone's like, it'd be really funny if you tried to make him do this or that. So I think it could be a possibility. We'll try it. So if it doesn't work out, it'll be a short LP and we'll move on to something else.
Do I need any of this? Hey.
Nah, not really. You're gonna get full F for everything in a second.
Oh.
Just a second.
I thought I was being smart.
I mean, you were, but basically, when you finish the pyramid, Pooh leaves. And he doesn't come back for a while, which is stupid and terrible because you barely had him. But anyway. Who's your favorite superhero? Captain Novalin. Will you be LPing Amnesia 2? We discussed it a little earlier, I might be. Machine of the Pigs? It's possible. Favorite Pokemon is Venusaur. Chaiti is okay. Mal likes it a lot more than I do. We will not LP Donkey Kong 64. There's very few games I'll just flat out tell you we won't do. We will not do Donkey Kong 64. It won't happen. We have historically been doing Donkey Kong Country games every October. Last October we did the first one. This October we're doing the second one. Next October we'll probably do the third one. And then after that, if we're still doing Let's Plays, we'll do Donkey Kong Country Returns. We will skip 64. The death count is still 3-3. Still 3-3. No one's died anymore. Hopefully there won't be any more deaths. Steven, have you ever beat Earthbound in one sitting before? I don't think so. I'm pretty sure I haven't. I've beat it in 3 sittings, but not one. Or rather, I have beat it in one sitting, but I wasn't actively playing the entire time. It was at a con for Starmen, and we like turned it on, and we didn't turn it off till we beat it. But we didn't play like everyone took turns, you know, essentially. Someone would play, and then other people were off doing their own thing. Someone would come in and pick up the controller and take over. So I barely saw what happened. This is the first time I've sat in front of a TV for, you know, going on 12 hours just playing Earthbound, beating it start to finish. I've never done that before. It's kind of fun. I kind of like it. Someone wants to know, where did Pooh go? Pooh leaves. His master comes down from the sky and says, hey, bro, we're going to teach you this really sweet move. So come with us. And then he leaves and he comes back later. You're obviously not going to get away.
Why?
If you can't get away, you're not going to get away. Like, you have so much PP. I don't know why on earth you did not just use your friggin' Yeah, good luck. Oh my god, Mal. You could have used your rockin' attack over and over again. You're gonna get to Dungeon Man.
Make the mark?
Yeah, I am. Oh my god. You had so much PP. You could have used rockin' over and over till they were dead. And just went to Dungeon Man where it's a free recovery. Mal. 4 tallies for Mal. She is now losing. Anyway, Player's Choice in South Carolina. Player's Choice, they actually have two stores. They have one in Charlotte, which is in North Carolina, but the one that I frequent is in Myrtle Beach Mall. If you Google Myrtle Beach Mall, that's the same place. You got the key to the tower, right?
Yeah.
We're not counting individual character deaths. We're not doing that. It's only if every member of your party dies. If every member of your party dies and you basically get game over, then you lose. You don't have any PP, do you?
No.
Well, that's one way to do it. Oh god, Paul and Jeff are dead. I have no psychic abilities. Alright, so you should get in there. I'm surprised you didn't suffer another death right there. So when do you want to switch back off? Sucks for you. Wow, that's awful. That is awful. You're not gonna get away. You're not gonna get away, Mal. Oh, that's terrible. No psychic points whatsoever. You might as well run. I mean, you're not gonna live. The coffee will kill you and you have no way to recover. Lucky. You need to find a bench so fast.
No.
You're dead! You gotta run as fast as you freaking can! This sucks.
Yeah, I know. Tell me about it.
This is awful. And you don't have any money either. You got it. No whammies. You're being so careful. You got it. Well, there's your PP back, so you should be able to survive anything. Ness is healthy this story. Paul and Jeff are dead. You're gonna want to grab some money out of the ATM. Otherwise, you're not gonna be able to pay for this. But you can ask him how much it's gonna cost. So you need $400. The death count right now is 5-7. Mouse died 5 times, I've died 3. To be fair, that was a pretty piss poor predicament she was in, but still
counts.
So
we're only counting one of my deaths and 3 of yours?
Not quite. But you should probably decide on a spot to switch me, so I have the opportunity to lose. When do you want to switch? You want to switch, Deep Darkness, and then you do Stonehenge, or do you want to do Deep Darkness and have me do Stonehenge?
Doesn't matter. You can do Brick Road if you want. I hate this music, so I'd rather not have to focus on it. It gives me a headache.
I'll do Brick Road, you do Deep Darkness, and I'll do Stonehenge.
Okay.
I like this part of the game. It's real easy, it's straightforward, it's not very difficult, which is why it's real easy. It's also really funny. You have things like this. Even though you can't get up there now, you might be able to later. Brick Road. Your first goal is to reach the 4 ropes. Brick Road.
Can you a little bit? So I have space to do this. I need elbow space.
Dear God. we haven't really... What the heck's going on? Once a dungeon is built, monsters always start moving in.
Brick Road.
This is the wrong way.
Brick Road.
Here we go. Is that an enemy? Items that are easy to get to are always disappointing.
Brick Road.
Ness and his friends got $5. That's not disappointing, it's $5. What's this?
20.
Snake! How many snakes do I freaking have?
You have a viper, a snake, and another one.
Mummy wraps? You can sell this garbage. There's some over here, right? Don't be a slacker. If you work hard, you'll get good stuff.
Brick Road.
I couldn't agree more with the opinion on the left billboard.
Brick Road.
What was the little guy that fought? Slimy Little Piles?
Super Plush Bear. Yeah, Slimy Little Piles. Super Plush Bear here to save the day.
I silly with Slimy Little Pies.
Gross. I don't want a Slimy Little Pie. I build a bulletin board without a message.
Brick Road.
The second one or third one?
Third. You didn't know?
I didn't remember. I knew it was one of them. Dally's clock, man. You know how rare those are to see here? That's an enemy from Moonside. The chance of them showing up here is, like, ridiculously slim, but it can happen. This is the second floor of my body.
Brick Road.
What's your favorite,
What's a dungeon? Sorry. What?
What's your favorite Ravnica guild?
Red, white. I don't know what that one's called.
I honestly would pick them on the logos.
Ness opened the present. Ness and his friends got $10. I put out a bulletin board, but it's probably unnecessary.
Brick Road.
Brick Road.
That's a hole down below. You don't have to worry about this for now.
Brick Road.
I think it's blue-green is my favorite based on the colors.
Pissed.
And black-white is cool looking.
I'm lost. Ah, I need to get down here, I think. What's the sign say? I'm curious now. Inside the dungeon, flash photography is prohibited.
Someone said Steven, Clemson or game chickens?
God, it's like a big thing here. You have to pick a side, and I'm always like, I hate football. And everyone's like... But I don't care. You are standing right around my belly button.
Brick Road.
No whammies? What's over here? I don't freaking know. This music is one of my greatest accomplishments.
Everyone is saying stuff and then signing it Brick Road.
It smells like flowers here. If you can't smell it, your nose must be stuffy.
Someone wants to know what your favorite sports team is, and what is it? What is it?
The Packers.
Yes,
that's the Packers,
right.
The Houston.
That's right.
The Houston has. Ness open present. There's a pizza! Gross, how long has that been there? Dungeon exploration is tough, but it's also fun. Road. Sudden guts pill, yay. Things I never use. Not that it's bad, it's just I never use it. What's this? Piece like caramel. Aw, we gave it to Jeff to be mean. Is this the petting zoo part? This is the third floor of my body.
Brick Road.
Mad duck. They could be a nice pet if they stay far away. Gruff goat. They are a really gruff kind of goat. Oh, what is Dick Cheney's favorite thing?
Dick Cheney.
Slimy little pile. He's a bad habit of burping. He's a bad habit of beating the snot out of Mallory. I went there. Wet towel. He's got too much stuff. Probably too much freaking garbage. Mummy wrap. Drop. Pharaoh's curse? What's that even do?
I want my tea.
An ectoplasmic ooze is disgorged out of the dreadful box, and the enemy may be poisoned.
I read that earlier, and I was like, what?
I'd rather have space for crap I actually care about. Like peanut cheese bars.
Some good pills.
Actually, it's a diamond band. I was like, why shouldn't you wear this? Just gonna get rid of a few things here. Like the crystal charm. Something got spilled. That's mummy wrap again. And what does Jeff have that's in Apes on the Trail? Let's just give this to, Oh, wait, he got the slime generator.
Mm-hmm.
I don't actually want the wet towel. I just did that because I was thinking about it. But that's okay.
You know what the name of the song is called? How It's Made music?
How It's Made?
That's what it sounds like!
A little bit, yeah. Good job, you finally made it. There's a board upstairs that says that. Brick Road. Let's go see if he was actually telling the truth. Good job, you finally made it. Brick Road. That face is mine. Feel free to talk to it. Brick Road.
Who's winning a fight, Sagan or Kepler?
I watch this happen often, and Kepler's more aggressive. Sagan's just kind of like, dude, let's just chill and be homeboys. And Kepler's like, I'm crazy. But when it comes right down to it, Sagan's the alpha cat, I think. Welcome. Long time no see. Mr. Jeff, we met in Winters a long time ago. I'm Rick Roach.
I'm the crazy man.
Dr. Anon has finally made me Dungeon Man. If you want, I'll come with you guys for a while. The return hole is over there. Jump in that hole and then walk out.
My glasses are gross. They need to get clean.
Return hole. Jump in with all your courage.
They said I could be anything I wanted, so I became a dungeon.
I like that. Alright, in another hole. And we're out. I have some money. I'm gonna actually save here, so we don't get stuck again in a bad spot. Cool. Dungeon Man does come with us here. This is actually a fairly good place to level up. Because
they said it could be anything I wanted, so I became Brick Road.
You'll notice he's actually a member of the party and follows us around, which is pretty sweet. Also, we have the teddy bear! That's awesome. It's really cool having him because he does a piss load of damage. We should be able to just bash stuff and be okay because Brick Road will attack. 47, 108, 94. Dungeon Man. Oh my god. I'm like about to show you guys how cool this is. This is really neat, guys. He does lots of damage. Oh my god! 420. That's what I was talking about. He does a lot of damage.
Cave Johnson reminds me of Brick Road.
Super Plush Bear, no! You know, screw attacking these guys. The only thing worth trying to get is the caterpillars, and I'm not sure they're down here. They might only be on the north side. Level 50. Right on. Go down here. Some of the best music in the game right here. This, oh crap, this is about to get hairy. Wow, 3? Okay, I can deal. I'm actually going to use my big stuff, and the reason I'm going to use my big stuff is because we'll actually be back in Brick Road, like, in a few seconds. So. No, Super Plush Bear, no! No, my Plush Bear! Some sheer fire damage, jump attacks, and the coolest looking animation in the game, also seizure inducing.
Oh, what's the other one I like?
Great job.
Maybe.
Where it's like,
I think so.
That's a lot of experience. Vial of Serum. Cool. Continue heading south. Ignore that guy. Alright, here we go. Gerg, oh no, I am getting caught in the palm trees. I cannot move. Well, if I cannot move, it is okay. Nessa makes me sad, but I must say goodbye here at my eternal resting place. And now, in Brick Road's eyes, he is going to be stuck there forever. Which is sad. So let's fight this thing. And then we have to go over there and talk to that one. It's a Marauder Octobot. Like I said, we're going to be back inside of Brick Road in a moment, so we can just use our crap and do lots of damage. Unless we don't hit it. That actually didn't do very much damage. I'm gonna knock your freaking socks off, you piece of crap. Come here. You wanna play? We're gonna play right now.
METC is here, and he's like, why is this so late? Why are you guys only right here?
Shut up, METC!
I told him
slimy little piles. Slimy little piles. It's interesting what has happened to us during this this playthrough. Me and Mal collectively have played worse on this playthrough of Earthbound than we ever have played ever.
Yeah.
We've also been unlucky. Some of the stuff that's happened to us has been bizarre early in the game. Like, it's one of those situations where an enemy's going to attack you, and it's like, okay, they're not going to use that same attack again. If they do, I'm going to die, but the odds of that are low. And then they did it again. And it happened over and over and over again. We had to do entire areas over. It was not good. Scary place called Deep Darkness on the other side. The monsters are very strong, and you can lose your health just by wandering in the swamp. Do you want to cross the river? Yeah. The swamp is bottomless. Even if you're swimming, you'll be dragged in. It's a different story if you have a submarine. So now we have to go back and talk to Brick Road. Submarine, I believe I have one in my old vehicle collection. Please enter me. He didn't say me, but it makes it funnier. Well, hello, Mr. Presence. How are you guys doing? Paula didn't have much health. Gamma, these sons of guns. That should probably take him out. Don't spill coffee on Paula! Piss, 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 piss. I think Paula will still die, though. Even if they die, I think Paula dies. Yeah. Whatever. I don't care. Paula. Screw you, Paula. I don't like you anyway. I will, however, revive you, because I'm a nice guy. What was it, $200?
Yep.
Alright. This stream will go on forever. We're good. Alright. Paul's back. Cool. And, let's go ahead and rest. Rocco. He fixed the pipe and it became Shield Killer! Oh my god, he actually did something for once! What I really want him to do is fix the bazooka, but... Oh my god! Yeah, screw you, you little pieces of crap. Friggin' dang it. Dang it. Friggin' dang. Blow him to hell. I'm gonna teach you to interrupt my bench, piece of crap. Scalding cup of coffee's like, oh yeah, well, I'm gonna scald you. And Ness is like, I'm gonna friggin' hit you with rock and gamma and you're gonna die. Never learn. Let's try that again. Full health, no whammies. No whammies.
Worker.
Maybe we can get through it by bashing. Because that has historically worked really well. Why should I attack the pro class?
We should pull back on.
Make a cool t-shirt. Reminds me of the t-shirt from Rocker's Modern Life. We didn't take any damage. There we go. Now we can get on our way. Thank god. Alright. 1700. Cup of coffee. Alright, let's go ahead and save here. $80,000 in the bank. Wow. Pretty much at the point where we have infinite money.
I like the guy in the background. Boom, 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 boom. Boom, 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 boom. Where are you going?
What?
Why are you going back into Brick Road?
To get the
submarine. Oh, forgot.
Why are you wasting time?
I'm not wasting time, I'm getting...
You know,
oh, hey, what's up, little butterfly? Bye. Don't need you. You are not needed. We have to get up there next to that taxi, which we will do momentarily. Basically, we have to go through everything we just did. But, I mean, there's pretty much no enemies here. There's a few, but we avoid them after we get off the first floor, so. Around here. Down. There, I mean, there's the possibility of running into, like, the diamond guys, like that. But, let's walk over here. Hopefully
that'll make him disappear. I'd rather not fight anybody right now. Yeah, here we go.
Ha, screw you guys. I'm up here.
I'll go right here. Yep. Third floor. And we just have to get down there. We dance. Anything interesting going on in the chat? There's an old submarine at the back of the dungeon. It can be used to cross the river. There's a goodbye exit over there. We'll take you to the submarine. Don't make a mistake on which exit you take. You need to take the goodbye exit. Hope to see you again. So if you go out the same exit that we went out earlier, you have to do the entire thing over again. But this time, the sign that was in the way before is no longer in the way, so now we can take the special exit. You like dancing?
I have a desire to watch how it's made.
Oh, here's something.
Sometimes I find myself on YouTube just watching how it's made episodes.
Talisman ribbon.
That's for Paula.
It's correct, because it is a ribbon.
Random t-shirt idea.
There we go. Yeah, we should have a t-shirt that just says ... Brick Road. That'd be pretty cool. We could do that. That'd be real easy. I set up the telephone line in the dungeon. I wonder if that's controversial. Brick Road. Old vehicle collection? This is my secret hobby. Brick Road. Come over here. This will give us infinite, instant full life. I think we already have full life, but just to double check. Jeff checked it. Yes, it can still work. One of Jeff's only lines in the game. Ness and his friends carried out the submarine because we can't show that. Skyrunner music.
Gooby. Brick Road.
You know the stream's getting good.
It's too late.
We still have almost 600 people. This is the same amount that we started with. Now more people are going to start coming because we're doing this. Things are going to get really good. I can tell.
Someone said you guys are weird.
We are weird, and I apologize. It's going to get worse.
That telescope is having some fun.
Heyo.
My favorite thing to do in Earthbound is to get the bicycle and ride around Deep Darkness with the bicycle.
Because the player's guide told you to?
No, actually, because I never saw the player's guide, really. I saw it on Starbound under the things people didn't know about Earthbound. Like, you can talk to the guys in the cars and whatever. But, I love how happy Ness looks, because he's riding his bicycle and plays the bicycle music, and he has that big grin on his face. It's like, doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo.
As you walk through the deep part of the swamp, you take damage. It's just what happens. You can't prevent that. Let's see, which way? Do I go down here, or is it, do I have to go further up? Yes, further up. Generally, what I do for Deep Darkness is I go around to where I need to use the Hawkeye. I use the Hawkeye, and then I got to take care of some other stuff. Got to get Escargot Express to take some of my crap. I'm going to have to go get some money and come back for that guy. I generally try to figure out exactly how much I need before I do that. So we'll enter into the dark part. From this point forward, like, you can't see.
What are our death totals at?
You have 593. Now so use the Hawkeye, and it opens up the rest of the map so you can actually see what's going on. Banana! Okay. There's an ATM down here. It's a convenient ATM, because it's an ATM in Deep Darkness, but it will charge you the same amount that you take out. Which is rather insane, in my opinion. So, we are going to utilize the powers of math, children. Because if we do that, we'll be in much better shape. Let's see. Looking pretty good right now. We didn't take a whole lot of damage from the swamp. Let's talk to this guy. Don't talk too loud. What do you want? Bye. Combat Yo-Yo. Paula, you don't need that. You liar. Multi-bottle rockets are 2139. Would be anything else? Have we even been using these? That's how I feel. I'm like, are we using these at all? I think I'm going to
I think we're going to sell one of the big bottle rockets so we have two multis. Three multis? Yeah, we'll do three. So let's sell off two of these. There we go. And let's see if there's anything else worth selling here. Did not mean to hit buy. Alright. Don't need a cup of coffee. Taking up space. Don't need the Biosera. I'm taking up space. Don't need the banana. $2 for a banana is crazy. Apparently don't need the point of defense. So get rid of that. We do not need the platinum band. We do not need the mummy wrap. Just crap we can get rid of. We do not need the sudden guts pill. Really getting rid of some stuff here. Okay. What else do we not need? Is that it? That might be it. I think that's it. Probably don't need the other stuff. What's the difference between the neutralizer and the shield killer? Shield killer kills the enemy's shields. Neutralizer sets everybody's stats back to the beginning. Slime generator makes it hard for enemies to do it. I think that's it. Okay, what I'm going to do is I need to call Escargo Express and get them to take the key to the tower. Because that would give me more slots. Otherwise, that's about it. I need to try and get use up these slots, or use up the food items. Otherwise, that's it. I would really like to buy some big some of the multis. Since I don't need a whole lot of money, well, it depends, actually. The salesman over here, isn't it? Yes. I'm not a bad guy. I came from the world's largest economic powers to the small rural village, so I could sell you crap. Do you want to buy? Do you want to heal? I want to buy. Diamond band.
We want it.
Yeah.
We want some diamond bands.
Charm coins. Alright. Oh. My iPod alive.
Math is fun.
Here's what we're going to do. My iPod's actually about to die. See, this is probably a bad idea, but that's okay. Live long enough for me to do this, iPod. This is math is good, kids. 5198 times 2. So we also want plus 6,000 for those charm coins. That's all we'll need here. Secret herbs are useful because they can revive people. Let's pick up 4 of those. So plus 380, plus 380, plus 380, plus 380. And bottle of DX water would be useful for Pooh, but we'll wait till we get a hold of him. 1790, 1716. And now let's go down and talk to the guy and figure out how much the multi-bottle rockets were, because we want 3 of those. Multi-bottle rockets is 2139, so we'll do plus 2139 equals 24333. Now we will subtract 3450, and yes, I am doing all this. We need to withdraw $20,883.
So you're gonna teleport out and then come back?
Yep. It is the best way. Otherwise, if we have to withdraw $21,000, they're gonna charge us $21,000.
Yeah, I know.
So it's gonna cost us $42,000 to do that. That's not worth it. So we're gonna teleport to, it doesn't really matter, any place you wanna go in particularly. Which haven't been in a while.
I'm on it.
This is hard. Got it.
Why didn't you just use Omega?
You mean Beta?
Or Beta.
Because we don't have it.
Pooh has it. Oh, wait, he's gone.
Tell Pooh to come back and use Teleport. While we're here... Well, I guess I should stop by the ATM first. 2883. Alright. my math is off, I will be so mad.
So mad.
We actually will need less because we'll end up selling our old stuff.
I'll just get everything.
But I'm just going to get what we need. We need 21,000 essentially, in addition to what we have. This is also going to be one of the last places in the game we actually buy stuff. We just won't need to. And since we've taken a little bit of damage, we'll go talk to our buddy Frank and introduce him to my
Thomas
friends.
Thomas is on.
Thomas! Hey, Thomas!
He said, you've been at this all day. Next weekend, I'm taking the two of you outside.
Yeah, Thomas is coming to visit next weekend, which is exciting. I would say it's been a while since I've seen him, but I actually didn't see him all
that
long.
It's been a while since I've seen him.
Yeah, it's been a while since Mal's seen him. So let's rest.
And yes, you can take us outside.
We would love to go outside.
We'll be out tomorrow. We got stuff to do.
Yeah. We're going to wake up late. But then we'll get some stuff done. Probably will. I'll probably be at Player's Choice tomorrow, actually, because I'd like to get sell that stuff. All right.
You moved closer to
I'm
me.
I'm sorry. I know you hate it when I'm close to you.
You're warm, and I'm trying to get tight.
You see that's the running start I'm getting here? All right, now let's go back to Deep Darkness.
Everyone's like, Thomas, and he hasn't said anything.
All right, now we have a ton of money. Make sure our, we have enough room here. Yeah, okay. Time to buy new stuff. Yes, we know you came from... Yeah, you're so great that you stand at the edge of the water and sell stuff to monkeys.
There's Thomas. He said sweater vest. I'm really excited to start looking my sweater vest soon.
Diamond band, Ness gets it. So sell off the platinum band. Did I get you anything else? Yeah, sure. Let's buy another diamond band for Jeff. Jeff gonna be swag, man. I just said that. I just used swag. You should divorce me now. What else we got? Charm coin. Which will you carry this, Ness? Equip it, yes. Would you like me to buy Mr. Saturn coin? Sure. Get you anything else? Yes. What would you like to do? Buy charm coin for Jeff. There we go. Extra 10. Would you like me to buy coin in events? Yes. Can I get you anything else? Sure. Is there anything else we need? We're going to buy 4 of these. Just got room. Pretty much everybody. Who's most likely to stay alive is Ness, so we'll give Ness 2 of them. And hope they work, also, because sometimes they don't work. Paula? Jeff was gonna buy.
Good job.
Sorry, I didn't even think about that. Alright. I hope Jeff doesn't need to use them because our inventory is gonna be full of multi-bottle rockets. Some people don't like multi-bottle rockets. I'm actually one of those people. I don't really like them because they make the game too easy, but at this point, when it's this late, we're taking this long to do the game, we're gonna freaking utilize them. Get into a boss battle, multi-bottle rocket. I mean, we're gonna use those the rest of the game. Like, get ready for that. I will send multi-baller rockets up everyone's anus until we beat the game. Which will happen. It's a good way to do it very quick. Multi-baller rocket in Jeff's inventory. One. Buy another one. Two. Let's buy another one. Three.
You got 20 minutes.
Until what?
Midnight.
I mean, if anyone thinks that we'll beat the game in 20 minutes, they obviously don't know how much is left in Earthbound. Like, it's not gonna happen, folks. It's not gonna happen. And because I can, I'm switching out all these big baller rockets for the multis. Does it make the game too easy? Yeah. Am I okay with that? Got 5 of them. Let's make haste. Now, they sold something in Scarba called piggy noses.
Mm-hmm.
And you can use the piggy. Oh, look, our first victim.
Oh, what?
That was Master Barf.
I saw it.
Why did we see that? Is that an enemy? What enemy is that?
I don't know. Give me the player's guide. Give me the player's guide.
What? That? I don't... Mm. Just freeze on this guy.
Where are we?
Deep darkness. Fast guard. Card crocodile. Eat it, son. Kind of like a sunflower in the background there. I don't know what to piss this enemy is.
Big pile of puke?
They use the same thing? Same...
I guess so.
That's weird. I don't know if I've ever fought these enemies, have I? I guess I have. I don't remember it. It must have been a while since I ran into them. Fire generally works well on this guy. Or a mother-loving multi-ball rocket. Burn in hell, you son of a gun! 2,000
damage. I never noticed the parrot has a phone on his head right here.
Yeah, just like the game. I'm taking no prisoners. I am not. You want to fight? We'll play. I'm getting through this game, and I'm doing it by any means necessary. You know, we'll play nice the first round. We'll do a nice little freeze gamma. See how you feel about it. If you're still alive, we'll shove a multi-baller rocket down your throat. Because I ain't playing. Regular bad son.
Very
you
nice.
Killed yourself, you stupid eel. I'm okay. Also, didn't we say that you were going to play this part?
I don't remember.
I think you were going to play this part and I was going to play Stonehenge, but you could play Stonehenge.
Okay.
What the piss is up with all the barf, man? I'm thinking I'm just going to continue to send multi-baller rockets their way. It's a pretty effective strategy. Let's just do this. Let's try to restrain ourselves a little bit. Just a little bit. I got a little nauseous, but that's okay. We'll keep up with the fire. And, here, have a big one. Have a big one. I'll play a little nice. 159, 22 damage, didn't do any damage. Big ball of rocket, nice 500 damage. Jeff is a nice guy. Jeff's a nice guy. Jeff has an item that does 2,000 damage to enemies. And it works on bosses. Maximum HP went up. Let's go ahead and, we gotta move past that enemy as fast as we can because he's going to come after us. Got around him. Lame, man, lame. Oh, you piece of crap. Oh, man. Attack. Freaking fire. Look, I don't have any crap. Slime generator. Just normal attack doesn't do very much damage. It didn't work on the pile of puke. He's probably as sticky can be, and that's a gross thought. Let's be nice and use life up on Paula. Paula, continue to use fire on this guy.
Oops.
What?
Trying to give someone a time to connect so they can hit someone else.
Ooh, not good. Can you just re-click it and it fixes it?
I don't know. I apologize to the person that was not spamming and I accidentally clicked
them. Oh, try to correct it if you can.
I did, but it said the same thing. It didn't say on, it said redo.
I think they can't speak for 10 minutes. I mean, it's not like we're not going anywhere. We'll be here in 10 minutes. It's just, I feel bad when that happens. Oh my god, there's a lot of enemies. Like, abnormal amount of enemies. Hey, I think I remember where to go. You have to go down and then up and around.
Yeah.
But let me make sure so I don't waste any time and also so I survive a little bit easier.
Hey, how about this? How about I play for a bit and you go take care of the chili and put it in things and put it in the fridge?
Okay, see where you are?
Yeah, I know. I know where to go.
You just hit down and around and then when you get up here, you go in the small area. That's it.
I know where to go.
I'm
going down here?
Yeah, fine. Did you just say, so where am I going? Yes, you are going down. Head down. Which is good because
anyway,
the enemies are there.
Will you put the chili in Tupperwares and turn off the crock pot?
Yes,
and
I would.
Actually, it'll be hot, so just leave
it alone. Yes, I will do that.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Chad will be ignored for a little bit. Just a little bit, though. There's a present. Chili is good.
Soup is good food.
That is also a great movie. It's called Jane Austen's Mafia, and it is fantastic.
I put this in a big one or several little ones?
I would do it in several little ones. They're sturdier and it's hot. Also, we can freeze some of them. This is what I'm gonna do. Where is the thing? There's a big scooper.
I got it. Did I just turn this off?
I'm gonna do this. So this person that I know and trust will, oops, I'm not used to it. Dang it. No, it does not give me the mod option. No, that does not work. I cannot click their name. It says voice, not mod.
Oh, now, if you click the little gear icon there...
Does that tell me?
It'll say chat help or something. See it?
Yeah.
It'll show you the list of commands and they're probably kind of
I'm gonna make someone we know...
Huh?
A mod for now. Someone we can trust.
Dan?
Dan's not here, so I'm sorry. I don't know if Thomas is still here, so I'm gonna do it to someone else. Someone that just typed a word.
Who is it?
I was gonna give it to METC. I don't have permission to do this. Never mind. / mod. And then username.
What's his username?
Capital METC 500. I'm saying.
Here you go.
Thank you.
You should be a mod. Actually, I don't know if it works in the Call of Duty, but if it does.
He said that's cute. Hasn't shown up in mine yet.
Maybe it didn't work.
We haven't been giving him any attention. Oh no, Petunia. Kill the Petunia, thank you. Yeah, it didn't make him a mod, so I don't know what to do.
Well, obviously he doesn't get to be a mod.
Is Thomas? Yeah, Thomas is here. Thomas is still here. But I can't do it. You have to do it on the Twitch chat, I think.
We'll just have it over show and go, everybody gets a mod. You be the mod. You.
Someone said, I feel like the chat is filled with toddlers who need attention 24/7. Someone told me to try the thing I tried that didn't work. And I also tried the thing where I go to their name on the viewer list and it didn't work.
You can just not worry about it.
Yeah.
Because I'm going to be back in like 4 seconds.
Will you unplug that when you're done?
Yeah. Need a bark yet?
I just got there.
Just have everyone defend and have a multi-ball market and the battle will be over immediately. FYI.
Alright.
It's real easy to do it that way. Maybe cheap, but whatever.
There we go. Starstorm. Starstorm was pretty cool. Yeah.
Picked up.
Casey Bat. I love the fact that I get that reference. Books. Well, it's a poem, but.
Oh my god.
Flashing is me drowning, that's what that is. Oh, Tim's Village. At what point does it trigger the going back to Onnit? At what point does it trigger going back to Onnit?
As soon as you walk out.
Oh.
It's not going back to Onnit, it's going to Stonehenge.
Well, don't you have to get the book?
Yeah, that's not yet.
Oh.
That happens when you get to the end of Stonehenge and you talk to Abbott and he's like, oh, the book. I've turned it.
Oh.
But there's a gun for Jeff and a garbage can in here.
Yeah, I got it. It's the death ray.
That's about it. Is there anything else in there?
Not particularly.
There's somebody who wants to trade stuff, and eventually it's worth something, like, to do that.
Like a Horn of Life? Yeah. That's it. Kepler's over there meowing at Steven like it's dinner time.
Guys need attention so bad. Said, please give us attention.
You want to take the chat?
Sure.
said if we don't have attention, we gonna go crazy.
Hi, buddy.
Say, you want to come over here too? We have the whole family on the couch. If you join us. He's relaxing. He's like, I need to relax. All right. Do you have any tips on building a new computer? I don't have a big budget and want to be able to run Guild Wars 2. You should be able to run most modern games on at least medium settings, which, by the way, outclasses consoles by like a large margin, even on medium settings, for at most like $700. Like, you shouldn't have to spend very much on a computer.
I'm doing the right thing, right?
Yes, you are. What I would do is, every once in a while, Lifehacker features articles on, building, like, a budget computer, or building the latest computer or something like that. Maybe look into that. Newegg has articles on stuff like that, too, so I would look up guides. And find a parts list, especially if you've never built before and you're not familiar with how parts work, like what you need, like sockets and things like that. So you can find a guide that gives you a list in your price range and power for what you're trying to do. Just take your time on Google and find something like that, and you should be able to build even with new parts and stuff. Like you wouldn't even have to use Sandy Bridge. You can use Ivy Bridge. You should still be able to build something for under $700. Pretty easy. And it'd be a nice computer. It wouldn't be, like, crappy. That would be a nice computer. $700, buying parts on Newegg, is going to give you a computer that is light years ahead of a computer you would spend $700 on in, like, Best Buy. So,
what?
Yeah. We originally said that we were going to play until midnight. It's not that we... Okay. For those just joining us, I'm sure there are people just joining us, we were going to play from noon until midnight. The idea was that we'd finish Earthbound probably around, like, maybe 9 o'clock at the very latest, maybe 10, and then we'd use the extra time to play other Super Nintendo games. That's changed a little bit. Probably not going to play other Super Nintendo games, although we might, depending on what time we finish, but we plan on finishing Earthbound. We will finish Earthbound. So... It's not going to end in 2 minutes. It's going to end in, like...
Whenever we finish.
Yeah.
Heavy bazooka!
Bam. Bam, 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 bam. I know it's lame, but, you should rearrange your items to put Heavy Bazooka in the top left slot.
It's lame.
Sorry. I'm a power user, man. When I get into a battle, I want to use the Heavy Bazooka with Jeff. And if you're in a rush, you need to hit quickly... See, now you've got to go find that thing.
Now I know where it is, though.
Yeah, but you're accidentally going to use the ATM card again. I'd be like...
You sorry, you look like an ATM machine.
Some of the enemies do. If there was a Mother 4, there might be ATM machines. Who knows? You can go through the trees, but... Save a little time.
I did not know that.
I did it earlier. But you were running the chat. What's
my favorite Tessie watcher up to?
It's so shocking. He was such a great guy. Yep, I have some chewing gum.
That's not how he said it.
Yep, I have some chewing gum.
Thank
Is that better? Thank you. Steven, do you know when Skyrim LP will be ending, or will this be a never-ending LP? It's not going to be a never-ending LP. It's just there's so much left to do.
Is Thomas still around?
What's his username? Kijante?
Yeah.
If he's around, I haven't seen him say anything in a while. Congratulations, you beat the game. Hooray! He said yep.
Thomas, we're wondering if you're staying with us or if you're just going to hang out with us.
Oh yeah, Thomas, did you want to stay here? Because you're welcome to stay here.
Yeah, we have a bed.
You have to like cats.
It's over there.
As long as you like cats, you're welcome to stay here.
I mean, they don't have to sleep with you. You can lock them out.
What is this? Don't have the pencil eraser, so you're gonna have to go through brick roads. Oh no! You'll live. Still loading.
Go back to this.
Oh, think it's loading.
I was probably answering a question, and now it's buried.
I'll find it. Oh, that sucks. Yeah, that's what I thought. I looked at that link and I was like, that link's wrong. So, the person who sent me the Spreadshirt link about the t-shirt, that's a generic link. Like, it just loads the t-shirt designer for me. You have to make a product and send me that, otherwise I'm not going to be able to see it. Oh. Now let me look for Thomas's answer. It matters not. I have a place in Garden City that I can stay, so whatever.
How far away is Garden City from us?
Garden City is past Surfside.
Yeah, I know. How far?
Yeah. 30 to 40 minute drive. If you want to stay here, you can. If you wanted to split it up and stay here and there, you can. If you're trying to see other people down that way, because it's a pretty far drive, so it's up to you. But you're welcome to stay here as long as you'd like. It's not a big deal. Just the kitties, the kitties. They'll be all like in your stuff and be like, "What's up? I'm a cat." But as long as you're okay with it, that's cool. Our buddy Austin just stayed with us. He only stayed with us one night, but he was over here a few nights, and he had a lot of fun. He loves cats, though. So. He says he'll do both. Let's check out this Greg card. Greg card. Pokemon Greg. The enemy is distracted by Greg's peg leg. Vine whip, it whips with vines. Nice. How do you make an emulator run fast and not lag? I mean, that's dependent upon the hardware that you're using. Yeah, I mean, the simplest way to put that is get better hardware. I mean, there's always occasions where you can adjust your software, your emulator, to adjust in certain ways where you can make it work better, but hardware is basically it. So you might need to upgrade something. So if you're running on like an old computer and you're using an emulator and it's not working quite right, yeah, they will come after you. But you should be faster. And you should go over to the lab first so you can save. They're easy though. Like, these are the same guys that Jeff would have fought. And there are four of you, so you shouldn't have a problem. METCF100, don't run it on a bad computer. Oh god, there's a lot of chats. Have either of you done a run in Earthbound Mother 3 where you have tried to get all the 128 items for all party members? Nope. Takes too long, don't have that much time. Can't do it. I've done interesting stuff like the T-Rex Bat Challenge and other things like that, but I've never bothered doing one. Have you ever watched How I Met Your Mother? Nope.
I've seen a few episodes.
Kill all the aliens. We'll do our best. Any plans on heading abroad for vacation? I mean, we're going to Boston in March for PAX East.
That's not abroad.
I know, but that's as far as we're gonna get. I mean, we would like to head other places, but it's not gonna happen soon. Money. So, when money is less of an issue, possibly. Go for the Sword of Kings since your fans love you so much. Aaron, you're a bad person.
He said that a few times.